In just moments from now, kickoff, maybe by that guy, Mike Nugent, maybe the best in the country, maybe Ohio State's MVP. Northwestern and the Buckeyes next. Just a couple minutes away from that, Ohio State defense led by A.J. Hawk. They'll try to shut down Northwestern and Brett Bazinet in just...
The great city of Chicago is ready to throw down. The undefeated Ohio State Buckeyes are in town to face Northwestern. The nation has discovered that the Ohio State defense is a combination of size, speed, and anger. It's the main reason the Buckeyes are undefeated and dreaming of their second national championship in 3 years. For the Northwestern Wildcats, tonight should be a handful. Offensively, they're smart, talented, and very capable of an upset. Tonight, for just the ninth time in the 78 years of Ryan Field, a Northwestern game will be played under the lights. Tonight, the Ohio State Buckeyes hope their undefeated record can withstand the glare. It's the sixth-ranked Buckeyes against the homestanding Northwestern Wildcats. And hello, everyone, and welcome to Evanston, Illinois. Alongside my partner, Andre Ware, I am Eric Collins. And well, so far, Ohio State, Andre, has done everything the doctor ordered. They've played three games. They've won them all. They're ranked sixth in the country. Yet they look very beatable.
Yeah, they do. And their formula for success has changed a little bit. It's not offense that they depend on. It's special teams and defense that create a lot of turnovers for them. They play a field position game, do just enough offensively to get the ball in the best weapon's hand, and that's the kicker, Mike Nugent.
Well, coming into this game, the Northwestern Wildcats have to feel very confident. They think they have all the ingredients for an upset. They have a potent offense led by a veteran, talented quarterback in Brett Bazinet.
Yeah, he's the guy that makes it all work. And he'll have to spread Ohio State out and take advantage of mismatches, get linebackers matched up against his running backs, slot receivers in space against those same linebackers, keep them in good plays in order to have some success against a good, sound Ohio State defense.
Now for Ohio State, when things get dicey, they always can rely on their secret weapon that no longer is much of a secret around the country. Let's go down to the field for Jimmy Dykes.
Eric, you're exactly right. Ohio State comes into this ballgame tonight with a major weapon in the form of the foot of place kicker Mike Nugent. This is a guy that's accounted for 31 of the 73 points that the Buckeyes have mustered up this year offensively. I stood with head coach Tim Tressel about an hour before the ballgame, and we watched Mike Nugent make 10 in a row between 40 and 50 yards out, going both directions on this field. He barely missed from 58 late in the warm-up period. I can tell you this. Coach Tressel said this is a guy right now that has the total respect of his teammates. He had 113 of the 116 votes for captain this year. And, Eric, there are some guys on the Ohio State. Some votes. Whoa. I know your partner up there probably doesn't agree with that, does he?
Something we shall talk about as this game progresses. Thank you, Jimmy. Well, we're expecting a very good one against two schools that are rich in tradition. The Ohio State Buckeyes and the Northwestern Wildcats, matchup number 70 all time. And the kickoff is just around the corner. Northwestern has won the toss, and they have deferred. Ohio State will receive. There's Randy Walker, now in his sixth season at Northwestern. He's an Ohio boy from Troy, Ohio. Was recruited to play for the Buckeyes by Woody Hayes, but he also was recruited as a guy by the name of Archie Griffin, and he thought he had a better chance to be a starter at running back somewhere else, so he went to Miami of Ohio. Northwestern, 1-3 on the year. Ohio State 3-0, and Northwestern has made their first mistake. Kickoff, and Ohio State will have very good field position to begin this contest.
Well, where we look at Mike Nugent on one sideline, Brian Huffman, the kicker for Northwestern has had his struggles along the way. That there, he kicks that one out of bounds, and Ohio State's going to start with that field position that we talked about.
Ohio State They've had some time to think about how well they've done so far this year. They haven't played in 2 weeks. Justin Zwick had a difficult time last go-around. He struggled against NC State. The Buckeyes won, but he wasn't necessarily on top of his game. Ohio State begins trying to pass the football, but Zwick can't get away from Nick Roach. A sack on the first play of the game, loss of five. Let's take a look at our Bud Light starting lineups. The Ohio State backs and receivers. Lydell Ross, he's had some fumble-itis so far this year. He's put three on the ground, and that has kind of raised the ire of Jim Tressel. Offensively, along that front line, Nick Mangold is a great one. The center is from Centerville, Ohio. How does that happen? He's a finalist for the Remington Award that goes out to the best collegiate center.
That is a pretty good one.
Second and 15. And up goes Ross. His first carry picks up a couple. It'll bring up third and long. Let's take a look at the defense, the way it lines up. For Northwestern, they've had all sorts of injury problems up front. Luis Castillo, we'll talk about him. He's really banged up, but he still is a force right in the middle of that Northwestern line. Tim McGarrigle has led the team in tackles in each of the last 2 years. And in the defensive backfield, Jeff Backus has all kinds of speed, and he's an Ohio kid. He's from Columbus. He would love to play well against his hometown team. Third and a bunch for Ohio State. Zwick, his first pass, out of bounds, incomplete, intended for Bam Childress, and it's a three and out for Ohio State.
Yeah, and this Northwestern defense has passed its first test. They've shuffled some guys around. Tim McGargle has moved inside the middle linebacker. Nick Roach has moved to wheel linebacker, making some changes along that defense to try to take advantage of matchups against this Ohio State offense. Talking to Greg Colby, the defensive coordinator for Northwestern, they feel confident they can stop Ohio State's offense.
Mark Fillmore back deep. He's an Ohio kid. Jumps over one of his blockers and gets out to the 37, maybe 38-yard line. Punt of 41 yards, return of 11. For Northwestern, they had some difficulty offensively a week ago up in the Metrodome taking on the Minnesota Golden Gophers. Part of the problem was that Brett Bazinet was knocked out of the game for a couple of series. He played with a sprained shoulder, but he wasn't as effective as he had been earlier in the year.
Yeah, he took a blow on a touchdown run and didn't come back till late in that ball game. By then, it was pretty much out of hand.
Noah Heron gets the carry. Taking a look at the Bud Light offense. For Northwestern, Noah Heron will split time with Terrell Jordan, but to begin the game, it's the senior from Mattawan, Michigan. Very frequently, Northwestern will have three wide receivers in the game. A lot of quickness on the outside for NU. Second down and six. Three receivers all to the right of Bazinet. Wants to go that direction. Pass complete. Jonathan Fields. Flag flies. That's a good pickup for Northwestern. We'll see if it will hold up.
Don't know if it's going to. There may be a little block early by one of the Northwestern wide receivers, but that's what they're going to have to do against this Ohio State defense. Brett Bazinet, you see him there, going to have to take advantage, finding his slot receivers matched up against linebackers in coverage, because let's face it, this isn't something they do week in and week out. They're very uncomfortable out
during
in space.
The play, holding, number two offense, 10 yards from the spot of the foul, repeat, second down.
Let's take a look at the defense for the Ohio State Buckeyes. Simon Fraser's a name we'll hear a lot about this evening. He'll line up anywhere possible on that defensive line. He's very effective on the inside as a pass rusher. A.J. Hawk and Bobby Carpenter, two of the fastest linebackers in the entire country. And in the middle of that secondary for Ohio State, Nate Sally will hit you. And Dante Whitner is a strong safety in the mold of former All-American at Ohio State, Mike Doss. He's a good one. Bazinet has time. Skips it out of bounds. The bounce pass goes incomplete. That'll bring up a third and long.
Yeah, just a pretty good job there covering by the Ohio State defense. Weren't trying to run any deep routes. It looked like all out routes by the three receivers to the near side. And Brett Bazinet, once you hold it and they get into their routes, there's nowhere to go. You got to pump it, maybe get into some type of scramble drill. And really a fine job of playing defense on that down by Ohio State's defense.
We saw a shot of Mark Snyder, the co-defensive coordinator for the Buckeyes, along with Mel Tucker. Vazanen on the run, complete. First down yards. Ashton Akins, coming off an injury, makes the catch for the first down. Gain of 20.
And there, Brett Vazanen shows you the experience. I talked to him yesterday, and he said he's just seeing things better. Here, just moving around with his legs. He never takes his eyes from down the field. And his wide receiver, Ashton Akins, does a good job of just sitting outside, right along the sideline, and able to turn up and get him a first down. But Brett Vazanen playing with a lot of confidence and understanding things a lot better this season.
Aaron with the football. Not much doing on the inside of that line.
Noah Heron's a guy I think that's going to have to play a big, big role in this football game. He'll get matched up against those two linebackers you talked about on the outside, A.J. Hawk and Bobby Carpenter. Both of them can run fairly well. But I got to favor the running back in that situation. They're both about the same speed. The running back knows where he's going. So he's cutting and getting in and out of breaks. It's going to be up to Brett Vazanen to find him in coverage, get him the ball on the move.
Vazanen this time rolling to his right. Another catch. Ashton Akins, his second reception.
And he's showing the real effects of that shoulder injury from last week. It was nice patience on the part of Brett Vazanen. Here, you think he's going to run out of room. He slows himself, kind of gathers his composure. And right there, just showing the numbers. Well, I'll tell you what, Ashton Akins, they missed him last week in last week's ball game. He's come back to really show why he should be in that lineup to play some pretty good football early in this ball game.
So far, Ohio State has come out with a little bit of sleep in their eye. Offensively, three and out. And now Northwestern has moved the chains a couple of times against them. Another first down, Noah Heron. A week ago, Ben Bazin had his bell run. Touchdown. But he had to pay the price. 15 yards out. He saw the pylon, went for it against the Golden Gophers. And listen to this. Getting the touchdown, but also getting a sprained shoulder.
I told him, you better get lower. He said, I am, but I was trying to lay out, get my team back in the game.
Noah Heron gets the ball. He's been featured on this drive.
And you see shoving and pushing and guys moving Ohio State defenders off the ball, even at the end of the whistle. But you know, they're characteristically good against the run inside. When a team like Northwestern comes up on your schedule, you've got people spread out. They do a good, sound job offensively at Northwestern and running their offense. They get A.J. Hawk and Bobby Carpenter out of space, where they're not used to being out there playing defense.
Eighth play of the drive. Bazinet. A dangerous pass complete to Mark Fillmore. With an update on Auburn, Tennessee. Let's go back.
Walker.
The SEC is crazy so far this year. Anyone can beat anyone.
You aren't kidding. I mean, it is. We're all over Tennessee in Knoxville.
Bazinet. Oh, almost has his pass picked off. And almost caught by Mark Fillmore. A couple of guys got their mitts on it, but it goes incomplete. Tyler Everett almost had his first interception of the year.
Yeah, here you just see zone coverage by Ohio State, and he's trying to get it in there on a three-step drop, and that's the first window between the linebacker and the corner. The second window is where he should have waited till he cleared the linebacker to go to Mark Fillmore in the second window.
Ryan Huffman, senior from Schaumburg, Illinois, on to attempt a 41-yard field goal. He's had his difficulties, to say the least, so far this year, but you wouldn't know it by that boot. Right down the gut, and Northwestern draws first blood. 3-0, Northwestern has come to play today against the sixth-ranked Buckeyes of Ohio State. That's the Baha'i Temple. Exiting in Wilmette, just a little bit up the road here from Evanston. Built back in 1953. It took 41 years to make that structure. Northwestern has gone first light against the Ohio State Buckeyes. A very impressive drive capped off by a 41-yard field goal, and history has repeated itself dubiously for Northwestern. They've had two kickoffs, and both of them have gone out of bounds, and that's an easy way to get in the doghouse of Randy Walker. Joel Howell's all sorts of trouble on the kickoffs so far.
It was kind of like a golfer that just kind of keep pulling the ball. Aim way right. You know, aim to right field, and therefore you will end up in the center. Wow. You can't keep giving Ohio State field position like this, because sooner or later, they're going to take advantage of it. They'll find some type of rhythm. And you get a chance to pin them down. You have to do that.
Once again, Ohio State will begin a possession on the 35. Ross with the football. Swarmed and brought down. Dominique Price leading the charge from a safety spot.
Well, you talk about formulas, and Ohio State's formula now has changed, but Northwestern, they got a bunch of guys around the line of scrimmage, about 8-9 guys around the line of scrimmage, and they are coming up fast and pursuing to the football. We talked about Tim McGargle moving inside to play the Mike linebacker spot. There he is on that play, reading things out, and I'll tell you, it is not easy to go from outside linebacker, then all of a sudden you are in the middle of the action, shedding blocks and things of that sort, but anybody can do it. It's that young man.
Ohio State wants to throw. Maybe not. Zwick's gonna run it. Not necessarily his specialty, but he picks up positive yards and gets close to a first down, gain of 7.
Well, that's usually Troy Smith when he gets an opportunity to come on the field. He certainly changes things and gives them a change of pace, but they don't have Justin Zwick to win football games. Just manage it, kind of like Craig Krenzel along the years. He was the starting quarterback there. Just manage the football team. Don't turn it over, which he has done early in the season. There you see on third down, just 25% on third downs. Way down in the country in that category.
In case you're wondering, there's 117 football programs in Division 1A. So there's only 5 teams that have scuffled worse in third down than Ohio State. Need to get to the 45. Lydell Ross has it. And he has the first down. The senior from Tampa, Florida. A gain of 6 on his first reception.
Now, Dominique Price did a good job of reading the screen. And then as he was pursuing up to try to tackle Lydell Ross, he slipped. And that's what allowed for Lydell Ross to pick up that first down. He rallied up, read everything out, got between the blockers, and started towards the ball carrier. Just slips, and they pick up the first down.
Ted Ginn has now checked into the game for Ohio State as one of the wide receivers. He's a true freshman. And Ohio State is expecting wonderful things out of him. That's Ginn in motion. Zwick throws. Intended for Ginn, and it's low.
Next pass is incomplete.
Well, that wasn't an easy throw he tried to make. He's throwing a corner route from the right hash mark all the way back across the field, and it's a dangerous pass because the longer that the pass stays in the air, you give defensive backs an opportunity to break on the football. He was actually pretty lucky that he skipped that one in there.
Now you can take your chances against Northwestern. They don't force a lot of turnovers. They have just 3 takeaways in their first 4 games.
You know, we're seeing something uncharacteristic of an Ohio State offense. You know, a couple weeks ago or this season, or in one ball game, they've gone for it on first down out of 24 plays. They've run on first down 18 times. So, I mean, this is uncharacteristic that they're throwing the football.
Inside handoff. Ross has it. And a good game. Best offensive play of the day so far for Ohio State. Gain of 7. Nick Roach brings him down.
And that's what they want to do. They want to get themselves in second down, third down, and short here, just a little underneath handoff, away from the flow. Lydell Ross gets his shoulder pads, and helmet pointed north and south. This is where Ohio State's effective. They can get themselves third down and medium, third down and short. They're not as predictable whether they're going to throw the football or run the football.
Maurice Hall checked into the game as one of the wide receivers for Ohio State. 5 receivers in the game, no backs. Zwick has a man wide open. It's Antonio Holmes. First down, Ohio State.
And just a little hitch route to the outside. and you have to respect his speed. Jeff Backus is as good an athlete as he is. He has got to respect the speed of Santonio Holmes. He pushes him off here. It's going to hook it up outside his zone. The football is in the air on the third step by the quarterback, Justin Swift.
Santonio Holmes is a good one.
Yes, he is. Talented young man.
Week two. He had 224 yards receiving against the Marshall Thundering Herd, second best all time at Ohio State. Swift wants a bundle. Going deep, has a man. Incomplete, intended for Holmes, but flags fly. Jeff Backus on the coverage. And it may have gotten a little bit too close to Mr. Holmes.
I want to know where the free safety is located. Because, I mean, it came right up the middle of the field. And I know the corner, after a certain in-zone coverage, after you're threatened at some point, you have to pick up man-to-man. But that's the play for the
pass
safety.
Interference. Defense, number 28, 15 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
Brian Hines is the guy I'm talking about. You see Santonio Holmes sets him outside and going to go to a deep post route, and it is pass interference. But that young man there, number 21, Brian Hines, he's the center fielder. You cannot allow a wide receiver to get deeper than you on any route.
First and 10, no backs in the backfield. Swift, double clutches, pass complete. That's Roy Hall, kid from Cleveland, Ohio, his first catch of the day. His sixth on the year. He's a big fella. 6'3", 230 pounds.
That's a big target. He's got some wheels as well. Ohio State, you talk about them, and they don't do things that, they get themselves beat. And been frustrating for Coach Tressel because they turned the ball over offensively, but boy, they have found some rhythm here in the first quarter.
It goes to Lionel Ross, ties the left side, tripped up. Good tackle on the outside by Dominique Price. We're just getting started. 5:52 remaining, first quarter here in Evanston, Illinois. Historic Bryant Field is our venue. I'm Eric Collins, Andre Ware's by my side. Jimmy Dykes is in the building as well. Northwestern got this game started with a 41-yard field goal by Brian Huffman, the captain, 11-play, 38-yard drive. Northwestern bucking for an upset.
Ohio State offensively going to emulate it. Northwestern spreading people out. Four and five wide receivers, empty backfield.
Zwick, quick pass over the middle, intended for the tight end Ryan Hanby, and it's knocked away. That'll bring up fourth down. Brian Hines on the defense. Good play by the former walk-on.
Yeah, he gets matched up man-to-man against the tight end because they go all out on a blitz. And a fine job of covering there. He's going to make sure he made the for sure tackle, but was able to get his right arm in there and just kind of rake the football out.
And now, Heisman Trophy candidate Mike Nugent comes on. So far in the year, he's 8 out of 9. His only miss was a 53-yarder. This one should be no problem at all. 33 yards, piece of cake. It's a tie game, 3-3. 5:09 remaining, first quarter. The Windy City is electrified with college football here on this Saturday evening. We're in Evanston, first suburb north. Right along Lake Michigan. The fans have come from Columbus, Ohio, and all parts of the Buckeye State in droves. Filled up Lion Field, good mixture of purple and red. We have a sellout, first sellout of the season here for the Northwestern Wildcats. Mike Nugent getting ready to put toe to leather to get this one on. Backus with field on the 5. Backus returned one for a touchdown a week ago. Trying to go 2 for 2. Only the kicker to beat, and Nugent trips it up at the 50.
Well, you start making plays like that, you get Heisman consideration.
Return of 49 yards, and Mike Nugent had to use some of that uncommon athleticism for a kicker to stop the former Mr. Football from Ohio, Jeff Backus.
Well, you see Jeff Backus. You mentioned the fact he tipped one last week, and it was right up the gut. Same here, breaking tackles, and that's what you need in a return man. There, just give the kicker a move. He's committed one way. Jump over him or something, make a play, and get yourself in the end zone.
So great starting field position for the Wildcats of Northwestern. Bazinet from the gun, looking left, throws left. Pass complete for a nominal gain. Last week, Jeff Backus, 97 yards away, took it all the way home.
Man, right here, just right up the gut. There's one tackle, two he makes, two he misses, and then Reese Lloyd, the kicker. There's no way he's going to catch him. North and south, touchdown, Jeff Backus.
If the folks back in Ohio are scratching their heads and saying that name sounds familiar, it should. He won a state championship at Upper Arlington High School. He was the tailback. Led the state in rushing yards. Converted to cornerback here collegiately, and he's a great returner. Flags fly on the running play to the left.
Well, just not a, there's not a whole lot of room in the middle of that big offensive line for Northwestern and Noah Heron in the running game.
That'll push Northwestern back. Now let's go back to the studio. Matt, what's cooking? Ryan Moats. He can put up some numbers.
He's a player. You see that little movie put on the last defender? To go to the house, Jeff Backus needed a move like that on that kickoff return.
Saw Ryan Moats play a couple of weeks ago. He is a fun guy to watch. Got a lot of wiggle. After the penalty, it's now second down and 12. As in a quick flick complete to Fillmore. Fillmore gets good yards, but another flag is down on the field. Northwestern continues to shoot themselves in the foot. The National Football League.
Yeah, I talked to offensive coordinator Mike Dunbar yesterday. And last week in last week's game, he said, well, we'll have a chance against Ohio State. We feel like we can move the football against them if we just don't hurt ourselves. 12 drives in last week's game, all but one started behind the chains, and that was the drive that Bazinet got hurt on, the touchdown drive. So right now, they're shooting themselves in the foot once again.
Screen set up. Noah Heron has the football, but once again, third consecutive play, there's laundry on the field. E.J. Underwood came in to bust that play up.
Now they're going backwards in a hurry. That's not the idea when you're on offense.
During the play, holding, offense, number 76. The penalty is declined, third down.
I guess they feel like they've got enough yardage. It'd be kind of hard to convert this third down, but here, A.J. Hawk is a guy that's going to get held right there by the big left tackle, Trey Essex. Officials all over it before the play even really developed. They were throwing flags everywhere.
The Wildcats will have to get up to Winnetka. Third and 24. And they pick up two. That'll bring up fourth and 22, and the punt team will come on.
I'll tell you, there aren't a whole lot of plays in your playbook that convert third down and 24. So at that point, you have the mind frame of just playing field position. Get your punter on the field. He's got plenty of room in which to operate. And get out of the hands of Antonio Holmes here, who is dangerous as a returner.
Brian Huffman, his first punt. Good distance. Holmes has the football. And Holmes is brought down, but another flag is on the field. This time, it could be against Ohio State.
Just flags every play, it seems like, the last four or five plays.
It was a 43-yard punt and a negative 4-yard return. But that may change. Our ref referee, Dave Whitbolt, may have a dry lung pretty soon. The vocal cords are getting a workout.
Well, he's earning his money tonight. As well as all the other guys in the stripes that are throwing flags. This one is going to go against Ohio State.
A little bead in the whistle is starting to wear down a little bit.
Overuse.
During the play, holding on the receiving team number three. That penalty is declined. Illegal block in the back on the receiving team number 26. 10 yards in previous first down.
So Ohio State will begin this possession deep in their own territory.
They got the 2-for-1 special there and the choice which penalty they wanted. Back them up and force them to drive. I like what Northwestern's done here early in this first half of this football game defensively. Just kind of make Ohio State work themselves down the football field. Don't give up the big play. They had the pass interference that kept a drive alive. But, man, when you can hold a team like Ohio State to just a field goal.
We're going to take a timeout. It's a 3-3 game in the first quarter. It's a moon over Evanston. So far, we've had a good football game in terms of competitiveness. But it's been fairly sloppy. There's been a lot of flags so far on both teams. Ohio State begins this drive inside their own 10. Ball in the 9. Two backs behind Zwick, and they give it to Lionel Ross. Let's go back to the studio. Matt. Raskin throwing a little underwear ball.
Throwing it around a little bit. It's good to see change. Sometimes change is good. We saw that here. Ohio State's come out throwing the football early in this ball game.
Brandon Joe, the fullback, in front of Lionel Ross. Zwick wants to throw it. It's his tight end Hamby. He's brought down. Let's go down to the field and check in with Jimmy Dykes. Jimmy?
Hey, guys, how competitive and tough is Northwestern defensive tackle Luis Castile? Earlier this week, he said Ohio State has always been a great defense and a mediocre offense. Now, I know that's a pretty strong statement to make when you're healthy, but this is a guy that's playing tonight with a torn ligament in his left elbow, a broken thumb on his right hand. And I think if you're going to make statements like that, you would at least want to be full speed, wouldn't you?
Have two good limbs to kind of try to back it up. And he'll have to have surgery right after the season. Tommy John surgery on that elbow.
Hasn't lifted a weight since the season began. Third and one. Ohio State wants to throw for it. Oh, my. Almost disaster. Almost picked off by Herschel Henderson. He would have had an easy touchdown.
You know, he sat out last season with a knee injury and worked himself back and playing some pretty good football. Can play corner. Comes in their nickel situations. And here, Dustin Zwick from one side to the other. And what a break. That 6 points if he just holds on to the football. Good in zone coverage, reads everything out, breaks on the football, just got to finish.
Al Toronto, his second kick. Mark Fillmore has it at the 38. Fillmore, gain of close to 10. Good field position again for Northwestern. Familiar to the Buckeyes, he is the quarterback of Miami back in the national championship game 2 years ago. Almost a disaster. Pitch had to be corralled by Noah Heron. He got a very fortunate bounce, and he just goes out of bounds to save a negative play.
Yeah, you hit the nail on the head with that one. Just an errant pitch from the quarterback, Brett Bazinet, here trying to run the option. You see Noah Heron just bubble around, and that's his read, number 57 right there. The option off that young man. Boy, he was lucky to have that one bounce back into his arms.
As they went around the corner, he saw Big Mike Kubla. He got rid of it in a hurry. Coming the other way. Fillmore has it. Fillmore has a first down.
You know, every time Ohio State tries to get in an aggressive mode, Northwestern has the right play called at the right time to give themselves, we talked about it, an opportunity to be successful against a good Ohio State defense. They're catching them in the right defenses at the right time, calling the right plays. And Mike Dunbar, so far in this football game, has been fantastic in terms of play call.
They're going to have to check to see if they got the first down, and indeed they do. Andre, this is a good start for Northwestern in the sense that last week they really were beaten down by the Golden Gophers. They had season lows in passing yards and points and in total yards. They just didn't have it going on.
You talk to the coaching staff, and if something big happens against them, it's like, oh, my goodness, here we go again. But if they are able to play well early and hang in there, then all of a sudden, this football team becomes dangerous and they get confidence as the game goes on. Hey, we are set to have a fantastic football game.
Mazanan, first down, trying to get creative. Finally decides to abandon ship and throws that out of bounds. It'll bring up second down and 10.
And a smart play by an experienced quarterback. Don't want to force anything. You've got the ball in plus yardage situation. That means it's across the 50 in the opponent's side of the football field. Need a little bit more to get in field goal range. You want to make sure you try to come away with something here. Don't force a pass into coverage and have it picked off and give the momentum to the Ohio State Buckeyes.
Mazanay off to a good start. Four wide receivers in the game. Three to the left, one to the right. Handoff goes to Noah Heron. Heron with good explosion through a couple of tackles. Picks up 7 yards. Noah Heron had a great start to the game last week, but then was replaced for a couple of series by Terrell Jordan. This time around, getting a lot more of the snaps. Northwestern hanging tight against the sixth-ranked Ohio State Buckeyes. We've got a good one cooking. We're all tied up at 3. The Northwestern Wildcats starting to exude some confidence. They've had a couple of good drives. Now they need to convert into touchdowns. Big third down here. 3rd and 3. Bazinet wants to run for it, and Bazinet has the first down.
We were joking during the break about running a quarterback draw. And what does he do? He shows it into Noah Heron and gets the flow of the defense going one direction. He pulls it, and they do a good job of sealing on the outside here. It's going to show the football inside just enough to hold the Ohio State defense. Allows for a quarterback that with any wheels to get to the outside. Good job there by converting the first down. They are moving the football against a good defensive unit.
Manny Walker has taken his Northwestern Wildcats to 2 bowl games during his time here. Evanston. A little bit of a mix-up on the outside. Pass rolls high. That'll ring up a 2nd down and 10.
We'll try to just get a little flip screen or quick pass out to Jonathan Fields. And along the Ohio State defense going to read that thing out. Looks like Mike DeAndre there just kind of read it out, disrupted the whole play. And once again, experienced at quarterback, he just throws it away and come back and fight again on 2nd down.
Buckeyes bring the blitz. Bazinet trumps it. Screen goes to Fillmore. Good gain for the junior from Reynoldsburg, Ohio. Gain of 9 for Bobby Carpenter can bring him down.
You know, we talked with Mike Dunbar yesterday, the offensive coordinator from Northwestern. And when we asked him about the screen game, he just kind of winked and laughed as he was leaving, walking out, and came back and asked me another question. But you had to know that he was thinking, Ohio State's going to try to pressure us. Our best weapon to offset that pressure is a screen game outside. Get a block, and boy, it's big, big plays.
Noah Heron with that good power moves the chains. Another first down for the Cats.
Boy, it is dangerous when you can mix the run and the pass the way Northwestern has early in this football game. You're not as predictable. Teams defensively want to make you one-handed. They're one-dimensional as well. They want to take away the run or the pass and force you to do one or the other. But when they can't defend the run or the pass, or they don't know what's coming at them, man, is it difficult to call defenses.
Noah Heron behind Bazinet. Trouble. Pass incomplete. He's trying to throw the football away. Bazinet has to get it to Kim Thompson. Bobby Carpenter right in his face.
You know, before the night's over, this may be a game that statistically Brett Bazinet is not going to have good numbers, because he's going to have to throw the football away and just lead his football team, keep him in good situations. Not try to complete every pass, but move the down and distance markers. And there, on a couple of occasions, he's had to throw the football out of bounds just to come back on second down. Keep giving your offense a chance to be successful and not make big mistakes.
Another screen set up. Heron with the football. Heron with the touchdown. Noah Heron, a 14-yard touchdown for a score. His fourth touchdown of the year. And Northwestern takes a 9-3 lead.
It's been screens and screens and more screen passes. But boy, that's what happens when you get a defense that wants to play in man-to-man. A couple of blocks, and boy, you can pop a few in the creases.
It's now a 10-3 ball game. And the folks that have made the pilgrimage from Ohio here to Northwestern, they are stunned. Noah Heron makes the screen and finishes it off. 10-3 Northwestern. We talked about Northwestern feeling confident coming into this game, feeling that they had the proper ingredients, kind of put it in a pot, stir it up, and come up with an upset. And Randy Walker may just be able to walk the walk. He talked the talk yesterday, thinking that his team had a chance, and so far they're off to a rousing start, up 10-3.
You know, we get a chance to visit with the coaches, the home coaches, every week, and boy, it is exciting to sit in a room with Randy Walker and just kind of talk to him throughout the afternoon.
Joel Hollis keeps it in bounds, and maybe he didn't want to. On the return, Maurice Hall picking up great yardage for Ohio State. A big shot in the arm for the Buckeyes. Hall with the return of 42 yards.
And we described it, special teams and defense as are the ingredients for Ohio State here, just right up the gut. And then he's going to break a tackle, and then all of a sudden he's out to the outside, and it's the kicker who's going to end up making the tackle here to stop this from being a touchdown. Boy, Northwestern, they may have come out better just kicking it out of bounds, giving it to him on the 35-yard line.
By far the best field position of the day for Northwestern. For Ohio State, they are in Northwestern territory. On first down, Zwick wants to throw, and he wants his deep man, Santonio Holmes, but the pass sails incomplete.
You know, sometimes football games are described as a game of chess, and right now Northwestern seems to be getting the better end of that deal. But what you want to force the other team to do is start to do things that are out of their character. And right now, Ohio State, because of, I don't know if it's pressure from the outside and all the talk about them not having success on offense, they come in here doing something that they're not known for doing. That's throwing the football. And right now, Northwestern has their number.
Zwick, 4 out of 9 so far in his early pass attempts. Movement on the line looked like on the left. Flag flies. Lionel Ross tackled at the line of scrimmage.
8, sometimes 9 guys on the line of scrimmage. A lot of purple jerseys around the football for Northwestern.
The Buckeyes will march back 5 yards. Let's go back to the studio. Matt Weiner, what's going on? The missed extra points.
It's mind-boggling.
Staggering.
Mind-boggling.
Third down conversions. Ohio State, 2 out of 5 so far. Pass complete to Holmes. Breaks a tackle. Trying to go somewhere. Loses the football. Kicks it and then falls on it. Tim McGarrigle knocked it away. But Holmes able to jump on it in a burnt disaster. Ohio State has been stubbing their toe all game long.
Yeah, here they're just going to swing it out wide to Santonio Holmes. And there, you've got to make that tackle if you're Northwestern's defense. But here, just a good job of raking it out. Tim McGargle, I talked about it, he's moved out inside from his outside linebacker position. And boy, he is playing some outstanding football for Northwestern.
So Toronto, his third punt. Fillmore standing deep, waves for the fair catch and makes it at the 9-yard line. That's where Northwestern will begin. They're already up by 7, looking for more here in Evanston, Illinois. Welcome back to Ryan Field here in Evanston, Illinois, and a quick peek at our Yamaha game track. We'll reveal that Ohio State is really up against it so far. They have scored a lone field goal. Northwestern has matched them with a field goal and got a touchdown on their last possession. 10-3 is our score. On first down, the give goes to Heron. He stumbles and falls. Here's our Yamaha game track. Mike Nugent does what he does best. His 57-3 field goal, but Northwestern would answer with a touchdown.
Yeah, Bazinet here in charge, doing what it takes as a quarterback to keep his football team in this game. There, a little screen pass to Noah Heron, who turns it in for a touchdown. And I felt like coming into this football game, he is a weapon offensively. That guy right there, Noah Heron, that they were going to have, and they were going to have to count on him to make plays.
Football. Brought down, it'll bring up a third down. A.J. Hawk in on the tackle. Jimmy, what's cooking down on the sidelines?
Well, I tell you what's cooking for Northwestern is not turning the ball over. They've only had one fumble all year. We saw yesterday in the Northwestern coach's office, the number one responsibility for the running backs, don't turn it over. You know why they don't? They practice with this ball every day in practice. It's covered in silk. It's very slick, difficult to hold on to. This is the reason right here why Northwestern, only one fumble all year, guys.
Thank you, Jimmy. Third and 6. Fumble right here. Would not be what the doctor ordered for Northwestern. They want to be very conservative and make sure they don't make any mistakes. Pass complete. First down for Northwestern.
How about Brent Bazinet and throwing the football in rhythm? Sean Herbert, reserve wide receiver, one of their top 5 guys. Just here, you look at the footwork, waiting on his guy. As soon as he is about to come out of his break, he's on time with the football. Sean Herbert does a good job pushing the defender inside, breaking the out route, and Bazinet right on time with the football. 10 of 15, and some of those missed opportunities there, the incompletions, have been because he was just throwing it away, surviving to get to the next down.
Bazinet has a man. Fillmore with the catch. Another big gain for Northwestern. Back to the studio we go. The Twin City train of Marion Barber III and Lawrence Maroney.
Yeah, still doing it, and boy, those two guys are one deadly combination together, and when you can run the football the way Minnesota does, boy, they give themselves a chance.
Northwestern, 100 more yards than Ohio State. Pass to Mark Fillmore is complete. Does a little tiptoe on the sidelines, and he stays in.
You know, as a quarterback, sometimes you get a feeling or you get yourself in a rhythm where you feel like you can complete everything. And right now, that's where Brent Bazinet is. Look at this football where he just drops it over the head of defenders. There was a big play earlier in this drive where he hits a crossing route right over the top of the linebackers, making every throw and throwing it where his receivers can come up with catches. Boy, he is in a rhythm.
Delayed handoff to Heron, the senior from Michigan. Another first down.
Brent Bazinet here, just outside with the football, getting the ball out in space to Jonathan Fields on this play. Then he's pulling it down, patience. Receivers waiting on the outside for him, and he drops it in. Right here, just a little scramble move, buying himself some time once again. And at the last possible second, another completion. There to Noah Heron, just on the outside, allowing Noah Heron to get himself into the end zone on a screen play. Brent Bazinet playing with a lot of confidence, having fun as a quarterback.
Design rollout to the right. Throws across his body, and he makes his first mistake. pass intercepted. Matt Salad, his first pick of the year. And that was a blunder.
Yeah, it was, because it just took an opportunity to put points on the board. They're down there in that plus territory again. And he just lets this one go just a little bit too high. And it's picked off for an interception, but here he's just scrambling around, buying himself some time. The confidence right there, just throws it a little bit too high and too long for Mark Fillmore. Right there, he wants it back right now. He knows.
Andre, maybe a little bit too much confidence right there for Bazin.
Maybe a little bit, but you know what? You got to have a little swagger to play that position. You can't go in there, you know, with nerves and jittery. You got to feel like you can get the job done. And he's playing that way right now. You're going to make some mistakes, though.
Antonio Pittman, his first carry, gain of 4. Pittman, a true freshman from Akron, Ohio. Hadn't seen much action coming into today's game, but he is the wave of the future. Yeah, at least that's what Jim Tressel thinks.
They feel like they can hit home runs with Pittman at the running back position, averaging over 8 yards a carry, and seen spot duty here and there, but they really, really like him at that position. He's going to push Lydell Ross, just as Lydell Ross did when he was a freshman, and he pushed Jonathan Wells, who was struggling in his senior year.
Swick. Pass complete to the fullback, Brandon Snitker. His first catch, the junior from Sandusky. That'll bring up a third and short.
Well, the game is just based on momentum, and Northwestern pretty much in that drive doing whatever they wanted to do offensively against one of the better defenses in the entire country. Then all of a sudden, you give a little life to this Ohio State football team, and here they come.
Ohio State has not lost to Northwestern since 1971. Third down play, the give goes to Pittman. Trying to power his way, and I don't think he got enough for the first down.
I think you're right. I think he's going to be short.
Luis Castillo right in the middle of that stack, and that's not a man you want to try too often.
Well, he is an impressive individual. You mentioned the fact he can't lift weights, but he plays a position where it takes a lot of strength and leverage. And, you know, bad elbow, bad thumb. You wonder how he fights inside. And you see him here in the middle of your screen. He's the first guy to make contact and just kind of shut things down. Sometimes you don't have to make the tackle. You just disrupt it for the other guys on your defense to come up and make a play. Look at all those purple jerseys and purple pants around the football making plays. He's able to pick up the first down.
Yeah, collective groan from the sellout crowd here at Ryan Field as the nose of the football just past the marker. Fresh set of downs for Ohio State. Here's Castillo back to work in the middle of that line for Northwestern. Pittman still in the game. The deep back with the football. Pittman, good first down yards. We had a chance to talk to Luis Castillo yesterday about his expectations for senior year.
It's an extremely difficult situation to come into your senior year, such high expectations, and have to deal with something the second play of the season. But, you know, the coaches have had a lot of faith in me, and, you know, they've told me I can't compete regardless of the injury. So, you know, tough it up and come out and have fun and play hard, yeah.
He's got a left arm that's virtually limp. He has to have Tommy John surgery at the end of the year. He broke his thumb 2 weeks ago against Kansas. He is the definition of the walking wounded, but he's still out there because his teammates need him. Pass outside. Santonio Holmes stays on his feet, goes out of bounds after a big gain for the Buckeyes.
And Justin Zwick took a lick from Louis Castillo there. In pass rush, he gets by the center, Nick Mangold, up the center of the defense, or the offensive line. And boy, he stands in there and throws one heck of a football. There you see Louis Castillo right there, beats his man, gets to the quarterback. He stands in there and throws an accurate football. Santonio Holmes, well, he is dangerous. He gets his hands on
the 43-yard line. Three receivers in the game for Ohio State. The give goes to the freshman Pittman. Not much there. To the studio we go. Ryan Motz must have been tired. He didn't score that time.
Yeah, Louisiana Tech's going to stop all that Fresno State going undefeated talk that I've heard all day long. We've got other ideas at home.
Maurice Hall checks in behind Justin Zwick. Set up the screen. Santonio Holmes. Not much going on there at all. That'll bring up a third down. And the Ravens. Big third down for Ohio State. Zwick wants to throw for it. Pocket collapsing. Gets across the 50 and dives close to first down yards. Andre, on that play, he looked a lot like his predecessor, Craig Krenzel.
It really did. And a guy that's not really known for his running ability or his ability to scramble. On two occasions, he's pulled it down and got first downs. And there, it was just sheer determination. In the middle of the field, Northwestern getting guys to Justin Zwick. We got to find a way to get him on the ground, but just a good overall athletic play.
Justin Zwick made his collegiate debut a season ago against the Northwestern Wildcats. Ohio State defeated him at the Horseshoe 20-0, and Zwick got a chance to mop up in that game. Actually replaced Scott McMullen that game as Craig Krenzel was out with an injury. Handoff goes to Pittman. Forced out of bounds after a gain of a couple.
Well, right now, it seems like Ohio State's plugged in pretty good offensively, moving the football and called mixing the pass and the run pretty good. Justin Zwick seems to finally have settled himself into this football game and got himself a rhythm going. But now that's when they become dangerous.
If Northwestern is looking for small victories, it's the fact that Ohio State, even though they're starting to pick up some yards, yeah, they've yet to hit him for the big play.
And it's a small win. And even if in this drive, Ohio State comes out, if you're able to hold them just to a field goal, talk about small wins in a football game, I think it'd be one for Northwestern.
Zwick throws a pass low and incomplete. It'll bring up a third down. Northwestern, so far this year, has absolutely been blitzed by big plays. So far through four games, they have allowed 12 touchdowns of 20 yards or more. That's a real problem area defensive coordinator Greg Colvin.
They had a couple last week, and when teams are able to run the football on them, then they become susceptible to the big play over the top in play action pass. So boy, they got to keep themselves away from that situation where Ohio State just starts to move the line of scrimmage and start winning that battle.
The Buckeyes need to get to the 36-yard line. Zwick just throws it away under heavy pressure. And what looked like a promising drive for Ohio State is going to end with a punt, more than likely.
Yeah, I thought Justin Zwick had his fullback here on this play early. Just give the ball to your playmakers, let them make plays. He misses his fullback out in the flat early, and then there he pays the price. Almost a late hit on that play, but Northwestern, talk about those small wins, they hold up again defensively.
Toronto to Fillmore. Northwestern will begin on the 13-yard line with a 10-3 lead here at Ryan Field. Welcome back to Evanston, Illinois. Ohio State has mustered just a 3-spot against the Northwestern Wildcats. Northwestern, a field goal and a touchdown on their ledger. They lead the Bucks 10-3. Ohio State ranks 6th in the country. But so far, they have looked sloppy. First down carry for a couple of yards for Northwestern. And yeah, Andre, they're ranked 6th in the country, are the Ohio State Buckeyes, but right now they're not doing anything well at all.
No, they're not playing like the number 6 ranked team in the country. Offensively, they're struggling. Defensively, seems like Northwestern has their card right now. And no way are they the number 6 team as of right now in this football game.
Well, they still have plenty of football to try and resurrect their reputation, but Jim Tressel's got to be worried. But then again, he doesn't get too worried because Ohio State knows how to win close games. They don't mind winning by just a point, a couple of points on last-minute field goals. They just want to get the W next to their name. We're going to take another quick trip back to Bristol and Matt Weiner. Matt?
Eric,
coming up at halftime. A couple of eye-opening scores from the SEC. One in the books, one in progress. The Hokies of Virginia Tech and West Virginia, their first loss of the season. And the Purdue Boilermakers invoke the spirit of 1976 in South Bend. Explanations forthcoming at the half.
Thank you, Matt. And Purdue, jeez, that offense is absolutely dominant. Third down, Northwestern wants to run the football. Noah Heron, close to first down yardage.
Well, I'll tell you what, Northwestern, they are as scrappy right now as I've seen them. Ashton Aikens coming in at the end of this play and throwing a block. Noah Heron fighting for yardage. They're going to be short on this first down attempt. I mean, trying to pick up the first down here, but boy, they are scrappy and fighting here early in this football game.
Ohio State had a bye last week.
Russ could have settled in. You know, a little rusty. It goes one or two ways. You have a lot of time to prepare. And then also, if you're in a rhythm, it kind of takes you out of it a little bit.
Santonio Holmes with the ball in room. Up the gut. Santonio heading for the goal line, and he finds it. In their fans, a 63-yard punt return for Santonio Holmes. And Ohio State, a team that hasn't done much on offense or defense, gets a pick-me-up on special teams.
Yeah, once again, it's either the defense that creates a turnover and they get points, or the special teams with Mike Nugent, you know, kicking field goals. Now it's Santonio Holmes with a huge punt return for a touchdown.
Nugent comes on to try and tie this game up. Hasn't missed an extra point in a couple of years. Knocks it home. And Ohio State has tied it up courtesy of Santonio Holmes in those quick feet. It's a 10-10 game here in Evanston. And Northwestern rally. We shall see. Hats off to Santonio Holmes. He's gotten his Buckeyes back in this game. A sophomore from Belgrade, Florida. 63 yards on a punt return. And that has breathed new life into the faithful here from Ohio State that have traveled all the way to the north suburbs of Chicago. Kickoff to Mike Nugent. Goes into the end zone, and Jeff Backus takes the knee.
Back to this punt return, and right here on your screen you're going to see Marvin Ward. His job is to kind of break down. He overruns it, but one of the Ohio State players throws one heck of a block. Brian Hines right here misses a tackle, and then all of a sudden it's Santonio Holmes against the kicker Brian Huffman, and it is over. That speed to burn, a good job in the punt game. The special teams once again, 63 yards for a touchdown.
Holmes now with four touchdowns on the year. Noah Heron with the carry on first down, brought down at the 24-yard line.
You know, it's important right now how Northwestern responds to a big play like that. They've had some opportunities where Herschel Henderson missed an interception, could have gone for a touchdown. They're driving down. Brett Bazinet throws an interception. And they were able to stop Ohio State, punted, and then a big punt return for a touchdown. But how do they respond right now? Because talking to their head coach, Randy Walker, he said once bad things happen to them, they sometimes go in the tank.
Blitz coming from A.J. Hawk. And Hawk finishes up on Noah Heron after a short game. Third and five. A.J. Hawk, junior from Centerville, Ohio. Coming off the left edge.
Yeah, you just see him here. Just speed, collapsing down and inside, and right there to make the play. Well, he's as good as any linebacker I've seen at reading plays and then getting to the football.
Third down and five. Flags flying. Bazinet throws it low, and I think there was movement in the backfield for Northwestern.
Yeah, I think this one's going to come back, and
been Noah Heron in that backfield. He split time last week with Terrell Jordan. Talking to him, he said Coach Walker told him whoever had the hot hand was going to stay in.
Offense number 33, the penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Jimmy, what's going on with you?
Guys, you're talking about A.J. Hawk. How about this? As a sophomore in high school, he was a 6-foot, 210-pound point guard on the basketball team. He said, you know what, I realized after my sophomore year, my future is probably in football. He also said, I didn't have much of a shooter's touch, but I was awfully good at driving the lane and getting to the hole. I never watched him play, but I got to figure what. He probably charged a few guys during his basketball days. What do you think?
I think so.
Ted Ginn trying his hand at a return. The freshman from Cleveland, Ohio. Doesn't do as well as Santonio Holmes, but he does gain 9 yards, and Ohio State will take over on the 40-yard line. First down and 10. Justin Zwick and Ohio State looking for their first offensive touchdown. Dangerous pass almost picked off by the middle linebacker, Tim McGarrigle.
Yeah, we talked about him making the switch from Will linebacker opposite the tight end out in space, and now he's in a crowded area in the middle of the field and makes one heck of a reaction on this play. Justin Zwick had a receiver wide open. Bam Childress, and all of a sudden, who's that man? Tim McGarrigle making one heck of a play for his football team.
Brandon Joe, the lone setback behind Zwick. 91 seconds remaining in the first half. Let's see if Ohio State is aggressive with the football. They will be. Zwick wants to throw it, has a man. Holmes comes back to get the football, and he's going to be close to first down yards, but it's going to bring up third down. We are here on the campus of Northwestern University, the sixth-ranked Buckeyes of Ohio State, taking on Northwestern. So far, Northwestern almost doubling their pleasure in terms of total yards, but Ohio State does have a special teams touchdown by that man, Santonio Holmes, and that means that we're all even. It's a 10-10 tie. And Holmes did indeed get the first down. So the chains move, first down and 10, fresh set of downs. Maurice Hall and Brandon Joe in the game. Behind Zwick. And Zwick is brought down. Another sack by the Northwestern defense. And a fumble gives the ball to the Cats. John Pickens got in there, stripped the football away, and gives it back to Northwestern.
Well, John Pickens rushes the passer, comes up with a sack, and Dominic Price is the guy who pounces on the football. They've got plenty of time, 54 seconds left in the half. But here you just see Pickens just fighting and scratching against the fullback. All of a sudden, the football comes out, and Dominic Price, the strong safety, is right there, number 8, to pick up the fumble. Boy, Northwestern at home fighting early in this football game.
Bazinet throws it out of bounds. Well, I guess no one has told the Northwestern Wildcats that they haven't defeated Ohio State in 24 games. Must be news to them. They think they have a chance.
Well, they do. And you know what? Offensively, the scheme that they run when Brett Bazinet is on, they're as good as anybody. And they can out-scheme you and get you in positions where they take advantage of the defense's weaknesses. They play solid enough on defense where they have in this ball game. They give themselves a chance. Then they're right here at home.
Bazinet 12 for 21. A hard count may have gotten a defender to jump for Ohio State. Aaron on the pitch out. Brought down, but may have been a penalty flag against Ohio State.
Jim Tressel trying to figure things out. It's got to have been a frustrating first half
offside
for Coach Tressel.
Number 75, 5 yards, repeat second down.
Well, Brett Bazinet shows you that experience again with a hard count.
Ohio State has dominated Northwestern over the last 33 years. They've won 24 games in a row Last time Northwestern won, it was actually in Columbus.
Yeah.
1971. Last time they won here in Evanston.
1958. Whoa. A long time ago.
Bazinet on second and five. Goes quickly out of bounds. Intended for Jonathan Fields. And it's third down with 21 seconds remaining. Decision time for Randy Walker.
No, I really like the game that Brett Bazinet, other than one mistake he made with the interception, but just you're in manageable situations, third down and five, second down and five. If it's not there, just throw the football away, come back and fight again the next down, because you have plenty of opportunities throughout this football game. But the fastest way to get yourself out of it is to turn the football over and start forcing it into coverage.
Another mistake by Northwestern. Looked like the left tackle, Trey Essex.
Well, maybe Simon Fraser, who jumped as well, and Northwestern's going to argue that it was Ohio State.
False start.
But no.
Offense. Number 76, 5 yards.
That was way across the formation. Trying to point down. Well, I saw somebody move.
You can't blame Trey Essex for getting a little jumpy. Simon Fraser, one of the best defensive linemen in the country.
Simon Fraser jumps. A couple of guys along that front jump.
Bazinet on the run, has a man, has a first down. Ashton Akins, gain of 11 for the senior from Detroit.
Boy, did they miss him last week. And with turf toe, he was out of that football game. 15 seconds left, and maybe need to get it a little bit closer for their kicker, Brian Huffman.
Timeout is called on the field by Northwestern. 15 seconds remaining. Can they get another score? We're back here at Ryan Field, where Jim Tressel doesn't sweat much, but he should be sweating right now. His Buckeyes up against it. Coming up on the College Game Day halftime report, the SEC had some interesting doings this afternoon. Virginia Tech Hokies taking on West Virginia with revenge on their mind. And Brady Quinn and the Fighting Irish having a difficult time against the Purdue Boilermakers.
Going into a buzzsaw.
On first down, Bazinet wants a bundle, gets nothing.
But you know, that's taking a shot. Moving coverage with your eyes in zone coverage and then coming back to the outside along the edges where you're not going to throw an interception. You're going to put the football where either your wide receiver, Mark Fillmore, can catch it or it's going out of bounds. Give yourself another opportunity on second down with 10 seconds. They can take another shot on the outside on the edges, try to move Brian Huffman a little bit closer.
They have timeouts to spare. After a complete pass, if he stays in bound, no worries, they'll call timeout. Fillmore gets good yards, and a timeout is immediately called with 3 seconds remaining in the first half. And Randy Walker will send on the field goal unit.
Yeah, I felt like they had to get right down around the 25-yard line to get in Brian Huffman's range. And he's a guy that's kicking right now. Doesn't have a whole lot of confidence, but he should be able to give this one a good shot.
Well, I'm sure that Brian Huffman doesn't want us to go on the Wayback Machine, but we have to. First game of the year, Northwestern at TCU. All sorts of problems for Huffman. He made just 1 out of 6 field goal attempts. And Northwestern lost in double overtime. No one feels worse about it than he did, and he's tried to come back strong, but it's been difficult going so far this year. He's just 5 out of 11 on the year. He is 1 for 1 so far today, so you know, there's improvement being made.
That's right. In golf, you know, you talk about, well, if I'm about 2 inches from being, you know, 2 or 3 under in terms of making putts, he's about 1 foot from making all 6 of them. That's how close he was. But boy, this is an opportunity right here at home to kind of kick his football team into the lead going into halftime. That would be huge during the first half.
And Jim Tressel wants to ice the senior. He calls timeout. doesn't happen very frequently in the first half of games.
He knows the history behind Brian Huffman and the game that he had against TCU. But when you look down the schedule for Northwestern, every team they've played this year, they've come into the game undefeated. TCU, Arizona State, Kansas, when they played them, they were undefeated, as well as Minnesota last week. And all of a sudden, here comes number six, Ohio State. They come in here with an undefeated record. So, boy, it hadn't been easy for Randy Walker and his staff. Schedule-wise, they're currently ranked 10th, the 10th toughest schedule in Division I football. And there it is, the win against Kansas here at home. Boy, it has been brutal. Every team, once again, undefeated that they've played this season.
This is the first game for Northwestern being played at night. Northwestern's played very few games at night over the years, just 8 lifetime in the history of Ryan Field. And it's kind of hard to believe that a school that spawned Ann Margaret, David Schwimmer, Penny Marshall, Charlton Heston, that they would have trouble performing under the lights. But lifetime, Northwestern is just 2-6 at home during night games. For the lead, Huffman makes the 40-yarder. And Huffman and the Wildcats scamper into the locker room after 30 minutes of play with a lead on the 6th-ranked team in the country. Northwestern on top, 13-10. There should be smiles on the faces of that entire locker room for Northwestern. Let's go down to the field, and Jimmy Dykes is standing by.
Randy, you carry a ton of momentum into that locker room with you. How are you going to bring that momentum back out with you the second half?
Well, you know, we got to calm them down, quite frankly. You know, we got a lot of half to play, and 30 minutes of football is going to be demanding. It's going to take our best effort from start to finish. It's good to go in playing well at the half, and we just got to finish this game up.
All right, buddy, good luck to you next half.
Thank you.
Guys.
Thank you, Jimmy. We have a dandy cooking right now at Evanston. Let's go back to the studio and Matt Weiner. The Ohio State Buckeyes have not played up to their 6th ranking in the country. They trail an aggressive Northwestern Wildcat team 13-10 after 30 minutes of Big Ten play. Ohio State may be a little bit rusty. They haven't played in 2 weeks. After making the trip to the Windy City, it took a while to kind of chip away that rust. And before they could wake up, well, they're down at halftime, 13-10. Their run of 4 consecutive wins dating back to last year is in jeopardy. Jim Tressel has never lost a conference opener so far in his first 4 years, says the head man at Ohio State. Randy Walker would love to hand him that loss. Walker, an Ohio guy, born and raised in Troy, Ohio, up close to Toledo. Ohio State, very near and dear to his heart growing up. He turned down a scholarship offer to play at Miami. Northwestern will begin with possession of the football here in the second half, and they will begin at the 22-yard line. Well, it's 13-10. Second half action. I'm Eric Collins alongside Andre Ware. And don't look now, Northwestern has a lead, but it could have been even bigger.
Yeah, they blew some opportunities, an interception for a touchdown. Brett Bazinet was in a rhythm, tried to get a little bit too much and threw an interception. So it actually could, the lead could actually be a little bit more than it is right now.
Northwestern, they have the football to begin the second half. Bazinet, just a couple of hiccups, but for the most part, he was solid in the first half. 14 out of 25, make it 15 out of 26. Pass complete. Let's go down on the field to Jimmy Dykes.
Guys, I talked to Jim Tressel as he came out of that Ohio State locker room. He said his biggest concern in the first half was when they had the turnover. He said, we know we can't do that, especially on the road and win football games. He then said, Jimmy, just like I told you before the ball game, we are not the number 6 ranked team in the country, and we've got to get better at everything we're doing right now on the football field. Guys.
Wow. Jim Tressel looking in the mirror and realizing his team may not be everything that they're advertised to be. They need to prove something to themselves and to the pollsters in the next 30 minutes.
Well, you know, where you're ranked to start the season is kind of misleading. And because you're Ohio State and you've had some success in the past, year in and year out, they're going to be a top 15, top 10 team always to start the season. And they're going to have to play their way out of that ranking. And I think Ohio State's ranked way higher than they should be. And obviously their head coach, he thinks that as well.
Jim Tressel and his Ohio State Buckeyes are trailing for the first time all year coming out of the locker room at halftime. Conversely, Northwestern has their first lead coming out of the locker room.
And then Northwestern, Brett Bazinet, they pick up offensively right where they finished the first half. Comes out, he's hot, slinging the ball around the field. And, you know, in an offense, we talked about it in the first half, in an offense like they run, they're able to spread you out and make you uncomfortable defensively, making linebackers have to play in space when they're used to playing in crowded areas. And all of a sudden, you're covering slot receivers as opposed to tight ends in a conventional offense. That gets frustrating.
Third down and five. Pass complete to Fields. Fields with good wiggle gets across the 50 out to the 46. Gain of 17. Aston Nabote with the tackle.
And Mike DeAndre there, we just talked about it, matched up on a slot receiver, Jonathan Fields, and he's going to come right in here on a blitz. Brett Bazinet right on time with the football right out of his break, allowing him a chance after he catches the football to advance it for positive yards. Once again, Eric, that linebacker matched up on a slot. I'd take the slot every time, 10 out of 10 downs.
Take the handoff to Heron. Bazinet throws it out of bounds. Let's take a look at our Yamaha game track. And offensively, Northwestern had twice as many yards as Ohio State, over 200, and they held the Buckeyes below 100. Owen Heron for Northwestern's only touchdown. But without this punt return for a touchdown, Andre, Ohio State really would be totally lost.
Yeah, and a couple of other missed opportunities on the part of Northwestern, but there's Antonio Holmes gets him right back in the football game, and we have got a tight one here in the second half.
Bazinet, hand off to Heron. Slow developing play, and that usually doesn't work against Ohio State. Quinn Pitcock there to bust things up.
Yeah, he stayed at home. They try a little misdirection, sprint Brett Bazinet out and bring Noah Heron underneath the opposite direction. But Quinn Pitta played the football well there. He's a good athlete. Has a vertical jump, guy 295 pounds at 36 inches. Has a sack on the season. He is a strong individual inside.
Third down and 10. Northwestern has done very well in this situation. Is low but scooped up by Jonathan Fields. Another big gainer for Fields in the Wildcats. 19 yards.
I mean, right as he passes the linebackers in zone coverage. Brett Bazinet in the pocket operating this Northwestern offense. You see the linebackers there. You see the body language. Frustrated because they're used to sticking helmets in there, hitting somebody on every play. Now all of a sudden they got to play out in space and they don't like it.
Bazinet out of the shotgun on first down. Hands it off to Heron. Trying the left side. Now Ohio State's at least run defense is as advertised. Yeah. They string that one out and throw them out of bounds.
Well, that's what Bobby Carpenter and A.J. Hawk, that's what they want to do. They want to tackle running backs with the football, running the football, as opposed to having him in space and already on the move, and they've got to adapt and come up and rally and make a play. So, boy, keep doing what you're doing. If you're Northwestern and Mike Dunbar, mixing the run and the pass, keeping Ohio State defensively off balance.
Ninth play of this drive. Bazinet with time. That's batted down by Dante Whitner.
Now, if you're Northwestern and you're down here around your 25-yard line, you know, this is Brian Huffman's field goal range. Here you see Brett Bazinet scrambling around, and he tries to force one there where he's been so good at just throwing the football away. But you want to preserve field position, give your kicker. At the very worst, you want to come out of this with a field goal. If you can pick up a first down, just wide open, hit it and pick it up. Otherwise, give Brian Huffman a chance to add to this lead.
Northwestern needs to get closer to the 15-yard line. Fillmore has it in space. First down, touchdown, Northwestern. Fillmore, his first career touchdown, comes at an opportune time for NU.
And they have rode that young man hard his teammates for years. He's been here, he's a junior, has rode it hard and not found a way to get in the end zone. He's gotten to the 1 yard line on a few occasions, but there, a breakaway screen on the outside. Bazinet right on time with the football. They get some good blocks on the outside, and Mark Fillmore gets it into the end zone.
For Fillmore, his 92nd career catch, his first touchdown. The kid from just outside of Columbus scores a touchdown against the Ohio State Buckeyes.
You're just pushing outside, coming underneath, and a good block by the left tackle, Trey Essex. And then from that point on, it's all Mark Fillmore.
Brett Fazinet, two touchdown passes, trying to work his way to an upset of Ohio State. Northwestern has Ohio State on the ropes, courtesy of that man, junior Mark Fillmore. His first career touchdown converts a very big third down with 6 points. The extra point is made, and it's a 10-point lead for Northwestern. A little swift kick set on at about the 32-yard line.
We're going to get another look at the screen. Brett Bazinet rolls one way, comes back. The left tackle right there. That's the key block by Trey Essex, the left tackle that frees Mark Fillmore. And he just does a fantastic job of running with the football. And he's going to celebrate his first one after this one. Because, boy, his teammates, we talked to him last week, teammates were just riding him hard for not being able to get himself into the end zone.
For Fillmore, now has 102 yards on 8 catches. Justin Zwick feeling some heat. He's going to have to make some plays for Ohio State. It goes to the senior tailback, Ryan Ross. Ross changes directions a couple of times. And gains a couple of yards. Well, 2002, right here on this field, Mark Fillmore thought he had his first career touchdown playing the right side of the end zone. Maybe if they had replay back then, they could reverse the call, but it was ruled that he juggled the football. No touchdown. Ohio State back then had Maurice Correct. He would score on this touchdown. It was answered by Jason Wright of NU. That closed the gap to 24-16 Ohio State, but that is as close as Northwestern got, because Mike Nugent, then a sophomore, almost as good as he is right now, makes the field goal, and Northwestern fell. Pass caught by the tight end Ryan Hamby, but a flag is down on the field.
Well, Nugent has been doing his number for a long time.
Nugent was a big deal of that championship team at Ohio State a couple of years ago.
Flag here, and look like Ohio State may have started a little early. And they do.
Well, that same game, Maurice Claret, playing in front of a night audience, had a little bit of trouble. This is kind of the first bump in the road for the talented freshman from Youngstown. Got to a little bit of a fight there on the sideline with running back coach Tim Spencer. And then Jim Tressel trying to calm him down. And well, that was kind of the beginning of difficult days for Maurice Claret. Of course, he was a big part of the national championship team, but national championship game 2 years ago was the last game Maurice played for Jim Tressel.
Things since have gone south for Maurice Correct. Hopefully someday in the future where he can get himself righted and get back in a football uniform, because I know it's got to be frustrating to be out of it.
Short pass complete to San Antonio Holmes. Jim Tressel wishes he had Maurice Claret still running for him. Look at the numbers a couple of years ago. Just a real force, yeah, offensively running that football. And this year's Ohio State team doesn't run the ball well at all as of yet.
No, and that right there, 471 by an individual as opposed to 363 by the entire team. So they're frustrated. Maurice Claret would be a junior right now. They don't have the running game that they had when he was in the lineup. And you got to think in the back of your mind, they kind of wish they had that type of weapon or a Maurice Claret.
3rd and 6, big play for Justin Zwick and the Buckeyes. Zwick throws it to no one in particular. Incomplete, and the punt team will have to come on.
Look, I thought Justin Zwick may
run for that first down. He was out there. He got outside the pocket, and it would have been close, but he stopped. He slowed down, and I think that's what Jim Tressel's telling him right now. Pull it down. You've made some plays with your legs early in this football game, converted two for a first down. Go ahead and stick your nose in there a little bit, get a little dirty, because all of a sudden, you're going to put the ball back in Northwestern's hands, and they are in a rhythm.
Phil Moore waves the right hand, makes the fair catch at the 25-yard line. Northwestern will take over there, looking for more. They're already up by 10. Ohio State fans came a long way to be miserable. They're not enjoying this one bit. It's a cold evening here in Evanston.
Jimmy's down there. It looks like his lips are freezing up.
Brett Bazinet on the run across the body. Throws incomplete. Let's go back down to the field. Jimmy, you staying warm?
You're right about the frozen lips. Hey, Randy Walker challenged his team this year, guys, coming off of a bowl game last year. A lot of returning starters. He said game night in the Big Ten is like walking across a 2x4. He said anyone can do it when the 2x4 is laying on the ground. Not so easy when the 2x4 gets to about 100 feet up in the air. And there you see in the Northwestern locker room, trust yourself. The words written on a 2x4, and the way this ball game is going right now, I say everyone in purple, they're doing pretty good walking across that 2x4 that's about 100 feet up in the air tonight.
And trust has not been a problem, Jimmy. So far, everyone has carried a load for Northwestern. Offensively, defensively, they have played very well on both sides of the ball.
Yeah, you're talking about trust and carrying the load. Northwestern right now in this ball game, 220 yards passing. Ohio State came in, ranked 8th in the country against the pass, only giving up 133 yards defensively through the air. Just riddling silly in this football game so far. Northwestern.
Those 104 total yards for Ohio State shouldn't be much of a surprise. Last time they played, NC State held them to just 137 yards in 60 minutes. Offense is an issue for Jim Tressel's club. Brett Bazinet doesn't want to make a mistake. Slides down well short of the first down. And that'll bring on the punt team.
You know, you talk about it, and you can say it over and over and over again, but with experience comes what Brett Bazinet is doing. He's throwing the football away when he needs to, allowing his offense an opportunity to come back and fight on second and third down. On third downs, if they're not there, they're playing well enough defensively. You don't want to make a big mistake trying to force the football, force your team into a turnover, punt it out of here, and let your defense take over and do the job that they've been doing.
Ryan Huffman has averaged 33 yards so far on three punts. Gets this one away just barely. Santonio Holmes on the return. Hit a couple of times and brought down, but there's a flag on the field.
Yeah, it's going to be holding against Ohio State. They're going to back him up. Marvin Ward, the gunner, down early. He was held.
So Ohio State will move it back 10 yards, down by 10.
Here, you're going to see it coming into your screen. The gunner right here, Marvin Ward. He's held, pulled off course there. And of course, there's good coverage right there by the entire group, the punt team, Northwestern. He's going to back Ohio State up a little bit. Western feeling pretty good defensively in this one.
That man is not feeling very well.
No, not at all.
Looked like he had a plate of bad sausage. He's not enjoying things here in Chicago, Illinois. On first down. Things going from bad to worse. Pass incomplete. Back to the studio we go. Now the Mac riding the shoulders of a hawk to a victory over an SEC team, and there's some athleticism in that Hawk family.
You know what? I would say there is. And A.J. Hawk is as good a linebacker as I've seen in a very, very long time. But they just don't seem to have Northwestern's number in this one yet.
Tripped up at the line of scrimmage. Lionel Ross continues to struggle. And Northwestern starting to feel good about themselves.
Yeah, we talked a little bit about Lydell Ross. His freshman year, he pushed Jonathan Wells, who was struggling. He was a freshman. Jonathan Wells was a senior. Started playing him, spot playing him a little bit. And then it kind of gave Jonathan Wells a spark.
mark. He went on to rush for over 1,000 yards. And Pittman now is the guy, the true freshman, who's come in a few times early in this ball game. He's pushing Lydell Ross.
Three wideouts in the game for Zwick. Pass time. Goes deep. Oh, my! What a catch! Roy Hall showing some strength. Gain of 49.
Let me tell you, that was all Roy Hall, because Justin Zwick was just throwing this in the air. And this is two occasions in which Brian Hines, the free safety, has allowed receivers to get behind him. And here, it just looks lost. He's turned around. You cannot allow a wide receiver, if you're the last line of defense and the free safety on a football team, to get behind you. And they are just making big plays. It was a pass interference play that set up a scoring opportunity for Ohio State early. They're a big play offensively again.
On first down, they go back to the ground with a little bit more energy that time. Lydell Ross gets good first down yards.
Watch the sophomore here, Ryan Hall. Justin Zwick is just throwing this thing up, and he throws it back in the middle of the field. At worst, it should have been picked off or tipped away by Brian Hines. If you're just playing the center of the field and you want to knock the pass down, how athletically he makes that play is just unbelievable to me. It's a fabulous play on the part of that young man, Roy Hall.
Roy Hall, just a sophomore from Cleveland. Some strong wrists on that one. Second down and two. Another handoff to Ross, trying to spin. And he'll be short of the first down. It'll bring up a very important third down.
Yeah, and it was third down before they hit that big 49-yarder. Northwestern would be off the field right now. But, boy, you start to breathe life back into Ohio State's lungs, and it'll make for a long afternoon or a long ball game, long second half of this football game. You cannot give them chances. When you have them down, you got to go ahead and step on them. A lot of coaches are afraid to do that, but put your foot on the neck and step on them a little bit. But you keep giving them opportunities, you wind up in a football game at the end at Ohio State.
Brandon Joe going back behind Zwick. He gets the football, and the big fella gets the first down and more. Chains move, fresh set of downs. Justin Zwick marks out his signals. Buckeyes trying to play it close to the vest, keeping on the ground. Gain of a couple of yards. Back to the field we go, and Jimmy Dykes.
Eric, you're right, playing it close to the vest. Talking to Ohio State coaches this week, they said once they get in the red zone, their play calling becomes maybe a little bit different, knowing that we don't want to do anything that would take a sure 3 points off the board from field goal kicker Mike Nugent coming in. Yes, we always want the seven, but they constantly drill into the offense in the red zone. Make sure we play with a high IQ right now. Make sure we at least get the three. Guys?
Yeah, they can do that when the game's tied or they're ahead. But there's a different philosophy that you have to take when you're behind. You need to put 7 points on the board. There's a lot of time in this one, though.
Zwick has his man. Holds it, the catch. And he has a first down. It'll be first down and goal to go from the 3 yard line after a gain of 12.
Boy, excellent throw and catch on the part of Justin Zwick and Santonio Holmes here. Just reading it out, gets to the top of his drop. The ball is out before the defender has an opportunity to make a play on this. Marvin Ward, look at this, just turns the defensive back, breaks it out, and the ball is right there on time as he comes out of his break. That's what you talk. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you shoot it to a spot. That takes timing. That's off-season work all during the week.
Dan White, the man in motion. The Gibbs goes to Lionel Ross, and Ross scores the touchdown. Well, that is by far the best that Ohio State has looked so far this evening. Lionel Ross scores the touchdown. His third of the year, and Ohio State has new life. They were on the ropes, Andre.
Oh, big time there. But you know what? They're right back in it now. And that philosophy that Jimmy just talked about, it brings Mike Nugent back into play. You're on an extra point, and then all they need is a field goal to tie it up.
Mike Nugent, no problem. Ohio State back within three. The big play by Roy Hall. The difference on that drive, 49 yards for the sophomore. Ohio State back in the hunt. here at Ryan Field in Evanston. Historic Ryan Field, a building that's been around for 78 years, has seen a good one. Eric Collins, Andre Ware, Jimmy Dykes. Watching Ohio State and Northwestern do battle in Big Ten play. The Buckeyes have really struggled offensively until that last drive. A big third down play to Roy Hall. Good for 49 yards. Seems to have broken up the Buckeyes. And it's now a three-point lead for Northwestern. Jeff Backus downs it in the end zone. Let's go get a Penn State update. Minnesota is going to be one tough customer the rest of the year, the way that they run the football, particularly here as the weather starts to get a little bit nippy around the upper Midwest. Noah Heron, first down carry, brought down by Jay Richardson.
How Northwestern, talk about it all the time, how you respond. You give up a big play and you give up points and still ahead in this football game, but how do you react when those things happen to your football team offensively? It's going to be on the shoulders of Brett Bazinet to get his team going. I think the best remedy for it is to come back with some points of your own.
Brett Bazinet has been the cat's meow in his head coach Randy Walker's eyes so far. He has made very few mistakes. That was a ball that was zipped in perfectly. Sean Herbert couldn't hang on. Good defense play.
Well, this is one that should have been caught right here, reading it out between the corner and the safety. And Brett Bazinet drills it right in there. You're going to get hit, son. You may as well catch it anyway. It's going to hurt nonetheless. Whether you catch it or you drop it.
Let's see how Bazinet bounces back from a little bit of disappointment. Third and seven, Northwestern.
Well, Eric, I don't know about you, but you could just feel it turning the other way.
Quick hitter as a man. Pass is complete to Fillmore. His ninth touch.
And they come right back with pretty much the same play, just a different offensive set between the corner and the safety again in cover two. And right there, Brett Bazinet, you've got to have a strong arm. Right there, you see the corner and the safety trying to get over the top. Tyler Everett and Brett Bazinet, you got to drill that. You can't put much air under it. And look at that, just 1 foot. It's all you need in college football. Fantastic throw and catch.
Bazinet wants to run with room. Gets out to the 45-yard line. Good decision by the junior. Gain of 14.
Well, that's the weakness of the defense. The play before the completion to Mark Fillmore, right between the corner and the safety, that is a weakness in the defense, as well as the middle of the football field in cover two. You're talking about two safeties and zone coverage under it. Well, he just drilled the shot in there. Mark Snyder, defense coordinator, hey, it's got to be a frustrating night trying to defend Northwestern tonight.
Noah Heron with the carry. Breaks a couple of tackles. Good game. A.J. Hawk finally wrestles him down.
You know, and that's what happens when you get teams and you get them in cover two. You remove a guy, one extra guy. You got a safety back there, and now all of a sudden, the Ohio State defense starts to spread out. Big, big blocking angles for the offensive line of Northwestern. A lot bigger holes for Noah Heron to run through.
Again with the football, and this time Simon Frazier, the senior, wraps him up and throws him down.
Well, they get a lot of guys around the line of scrimmage, and they're mixing coverages. I talked about two deep zone and mixing coverages here. You see a lot of guys around the football for Ohio State. It's because they're going man to man on the outside. I thought Brett Bazinet there would recognize it. See a lot of guys in the box trying to stop the run, pick it up. You got
Northwestern 10 out of 15 on third down. Jonathan Fields is checked into the game. He's in the slot. Flag flies before the play is started. Northwestern may have shot themselves in the foot right there.
False start offense. Number 9. 5 yards. The down remains third.
Just a little bit early here. You see Mark Fillmore trying to get a head start. And he's had one heck of a ball game, Randy Walker. Coach, one good football game here so far for Northwestern.
Third down and 10. Pass complete. Another first down for Northwestern. Jonathan Fields will not be denied. Gain of 17. The yardage has been amassed in big chunks for Bazinet and Northwestern.
Well, you saw Noah Heron go in motion, and it's a pick play for Jonathan Fields. He comes up from, he comes out of in motion here. You'll see Noah Heron here. It comes up the field, and he's going to clear it out underneath. And you see the little pick. It's just a natural pick. He comes wide open in the middle of the field. He's throwing, catching, and positive yards. Boy, Northwestern has dialed everything right offensively. Ohio State still searching defensively for a way to stop it.
First down carry. Heron. Nachtenfell is over. Bobby Carpenter and Heron doing battle in the middle of the field. And Heron gets 7.
Yeah, when you get them spread out like that, you try to go man-to-man, receivers don't have to block because they have to respect the passing game. And you're just running everybody off. Defensive backs, linebackers are running with the backs turned. All of a sudden, you unleash Noah Heron. When it's zone coverage, then you got to block a little bit. Northwestern's doing a heck of a job offensively.
Ninth play of the drive. This has consumed some time off the game clock. Heron, breaking tackles, throwing a stiff arm, gets inside the 10.
Well, did you get the sense yesterday when we talked to him that he was going to have a good ball game? It was just a calm resolve about him that you knew he would play well.
Fresh set of downs, first and 10. Bazinet fakes the inside handoff. Has a man complete. Herbert with the catch. Out of bounds at the 2. And Bazinet said, go forward a couple of yards, young man. We had ourselves a touchdown.
Yeah, and now they're coming with their nickel and dime packages for Ohio State. Instead of putting linebackers in, you're starting to see extra defensive backs. And that is why. Right now they got them spread everywhere, trying to play zone. Bazinet's doing a good job of finding open receivers. But when you get extra defensive backs in, now you don't have those big guys in the middle to block. And Noah Heron, you can unleash him.
Heron trying to battle. And they're going to say his forward progress was stopped.
Right on the, just inside the 1 yard line. The ball's probably going to be right up next to the goal line. Boy, I mean, defensively, they are searching. Mark Snyder and that Ohio State defense, they're searching.
Well, it's going to be a long walk from one end of the field to the other. Fourth quarter action. Northwestern looking for an upset. Northwestern up by 3 and knocking on the door. And Andre, this last play, they almost were in.
Yeah, Noah Heron here. You see the push, and you see Bobby Carpenter there. He shakes that tackle, fighting A.J. Hawk. And I didn't think the whistle had blown. You get a big push at the end of it. And there, he's across the goal line. I don't know, I guess the officials are saying they were blowing it dead.
Third and goal. He didn't get there.
I saw a surge and he was in. Maybe we're going to get a late one.
Touchdown. Touchdown, Northwestern.
Walker talked about this football team. Bad things happen sometimes. They're like, oh, here we go again. When they are able to stay in there with you and fight for a little while, they will give you their best. His football team right now, they're growing up. They had a tough road. We mentioned they faced, everybody they faced when they played them was undefeated, as well as Ohio State coming into this one.
Once again, Northwestern up by 10. Can you say upset?
It's been brewing in the pot, a big, big pot all night long.
Jim Tressel has no problem playing in close games, but this one's way too close even for him.
Yeah, here you see the surge right there. And it's the second effort. All the bodies have to come unraveled. Even the officials, it's kind of hard for them to see it right there. Noah Heron just gets lower than everybody else. Those big guys up front, Trevor Reese, Akechukwu and Dukwe, the left guard, Matt Ulrich, the right guard, they just wedge in there. That guy right there, we talked about it, talking to him yesterday, it was just knew he was ready to play.
Took a while?
Yeah, he said, you know, I hate waiting for night games. Yep. Sitting around all day long and you're watching, you get a chance to see other teams, but man, then about 1 o'clock, you're still not ready to kick off. You gotta wait a few more hours.
Aaron now is 79 yards rushing. Two touchdowns, one on the ground, one via the pass. Ohio State takes the short kickoff and runs it back to the 34. Let's go down in the field. Jimmy.
Hey, guys, history may be in the favor of Northwestern tonight. How about this? Head coach Randy Walker, in his 14 years as a head coach, he is 67 wins, 4 losses, and 1 tie when he has the lead after the third quarter. I also talked to Luis Castile right before the ballgame tonight. He came out and looked around for about after an hour before the ballgame. He said, Jimmy, I'm going to tell you this. Something special is going to happen in this building tonight. He said, I've never seen a crowd here this early, especially from our student section. He was right.
Northwestern's job now, stop Ohio State. They're up by 10. Ohio State had their best drive, the possession, prior to this one. This drive doesn't get off to a very good start. The pass is incomplete from the right arm of Justin Zwick.
And there's a guy right there. It's on his shoulders to get his football team back in this football game. They're going to have to ride the shoulder and the throwing arm of Justin Zwick, unlike any other time in his career, because Northwestern, they're not going to give up the run. They're going to stay deep and make him work his way down the football field, hopefully chewing up some clock as he goes.
Zwick, it's Pittman out of the backfield. And Pittman barely back to the line of scrimmage. Tim McGarrigle on the stop.
Hines in there as well, rallying to the football, and you wonder if he's the last line of defense, maybe somebody else is back there deep, because he's given up a couple of deep ones early in this ball game. But he's certainly rallying to the football, making a for sure tackle in the open field.
Northwestern has not given up a big play for a touchdown defensively so far today. That's been their real sticking point so far through their first 4 games.
And they got Ohio State right where they want them in third down and long in this situation.
The Buckeyes need to get to the 45. Zwick with time. Lots of it. As a man, tackle is made short of the first down. Van Childers on the catch. But Jeff Backus came up quickly and took out the legs. I believe it's going to bring up a fourth down. It's going to be very close, but I don't think Ohio State got enough for the first down.
Well, they're going to measure this, and it's going to be awfully close, but oh, there's a guy right there just wishing that somebody, once they get a hand on Justin Zwick, get him on the ground, but he does a good job of scrambling around, finding receivers, and boy, this is going to be close. Good for sure tackle by Jeff Backus. Yes, short. Ooh.
They're going to be
fingernail.
Slice of salami, sure. That's, you can't get much closer to a first down than that. But Jim Tressel, what's he going to do?
I think they're going to go for it. They're certainly sending the big unit on. Big fullback checking in. And you know, in situations like this, don't mess around. This quarterback sneak, you got a big old guy, 6'4", all 225 pounds of him. Just surging ahead behind your All-American candidate at center, Nick Mangold.
Brandon Joe, a senior from Westerville, Ohio, is the lone setback.
In a battle like this, it's whoever gets lower. Castillo is in there right over Mangold.
And Zwick gets the first down.
Man, don't even mess with that handoff stuff. Just let the quarterback surge for it. Like I mentioned, big old guy, big old strong quarterback, Justin Zwick. Move the chains.
It's a nippy evening here in Evanston. Jim Tressel, wherever he goes, wherever his team plays, is always the coolest customer. on the field.
And there, that right there is the enemy. The clock for Ohio State. Now, if you're Northwestern, you don't want to give them a big, easy score. Make them work their way down because you got a 10-point lead.
Zwick will run it this time. Face mask goes out of bounds after a gain of 8.
Does a good job of getting himself out of bounds, saving a timeout. The clock's going to stop. But here, just play action pass. He's going to step up. Big pocket for him, and he sees green pastures in front of him. Tim McGargle coming up from his middle linebacker slot. Boy, Justin Zwick gets himself out of bounds. Didn't have to use a timeout. Clock's going to stop. A lot of time left.
You always like that stiff arm to the face, man. That's a throwing arm, too.
Get him off you.
Brandon Joe stays in the game at tailback. Two receivers to the right. And off goes to Joe. Close to first down yards. Let's go back to the studio for a pack. Walter really got his season kick-started right here against Northwestern.
Yeah, he's a good one. I mean, I expected him to have a big season this year, and he has not disappointed.
Arizona State, 1-3 losses on the year for Northwestern. But today, they're looking like world beaters. Zwick on first down. Takes it for another first down for Ohio State. Gain of 11.
Boy, just missed tackles. I mean, they're getting there. They just got to wrap up and find a way to get this big fella on the ground. Pockets collapsing. Randy Walker right there telling him, just make sure you wrap up. Jeff Backus had about as good a shot on a quarterback. And I know defensive backs or linebackers, they want to take a shot on the quarterback. Trust me, if Jeff Backus just missed, he threw and he missed.
Taking their time, breaking the huddle. They're gonna be up against it. Play clock down to 8. They get it off. And Zwick wants a big play to the end zone. Incomplete, intended for home. Good coverage by Marvin Ward.
And he's trying to talk to the official to that side in the pass interference. That was a good job on coverage by Marvin Ward. You had to know that sooner or later, Ohio State was going to take a shot. They've been moving the football with Justin Fick, moving it, getting out of bounds, but then over the top and play action pass, you catch Northwestern up close to the line of scrimmage, expecting run, and man-to-man or just three deep zone on the outside. Can my guy get behind yours?
Ninth play of the drive for OSU. Make handoff to Hall. Zwick lobs it up. Has a man. Incomplete. Intended for Roy Nickel, the backup tight end. Nickel had his hands on it, but it would have been a difficult grab.
That was a good block by Ryan Humby, the tight end, to allow Justin Zwick to get outside. Right there, just a little touch pass over the top. Hung it in the air a little bit too long. A little bit of disappointment there because he knew he had an opportunity to kind of lob one over the top. Things are getting tight. 12 minutes left in this one. They're stopping the clock as they move the football.
Here comes the blitz. Pass complete. Holmes with the catch inside the 20. Gain of 16. Big play. Two sophomores hooking up. Zwick to Holmes.
Yeah, the Northwestern defense, they come with an all-out blitz, and they leave Marvin Ward right out there on an island by himself. And Santonio Holmes just turns him around. It's a lot of room to throw the football. It stays in the air a long time. They're basically the only two guys on the field. Everybody else is trapped inside. Look at this. Justin Zwick stands in the pocket, knows he's going to get hit. But it's a big-time completion.
It should go noted. A good block by Maurice Hall to give him a little bit extra time. Picked up the blitzer. And up goes to the freshman Pittman. Out by Tim McGarrigle. Gain of five.
That's a guy they like a whole lot. He's got a bright, bright future at Ohio State. He's the game breaker. A lot of speed. He's good size.
Maybe more than any position on the field, getting by instinctual.
And I think that's where you can have a guy come and step right in, because it is. It's all instincts, and can you run patiently?
Second and five to give again to the freshman. Pittman holding on to the football as a first down for Ohio State. This has been back-to-back good drives for the Buckeyes, just when they've needed it the most.
Watch here in big offensive line move. You see number 50. Doug Daddis just pull around a kick out block, down block, and receivers. Teddy Ginn blocking down the field for their running back. Lipton says this is a good answer to the touchdown drive that Northwestern had.
Let's see if Ohio State will get cute or if they'll keep it on the ground. They did try and go cute. A little bit of a fake, tried to get it to the tight end Hamby. Zwick, much to the pleasure, Jim Tressel, threw it out of bounds when nothing was working.
Well, you know, you can do that if you're having some success moving the football because it's stopping the clock. They've got still 10 and a half minutes left in this football game. The clock's not moving, but they are advancing the football. At times when they have to run, Justin Zwick has gotten himself out of bounds. And along the sideline, they've worked Santonio Holmes down the field, caught Northwestern in a blitz. And so they're not chewing up a whole lot of clock, but they're advancing the football.
Longest drive for either team so far this evening. This is the 14th play. Zwick searching. Running out of time. Brought down by a whole bunch of purple jerseys. Third down.
He's going out and then turned up and was expecting the football. He's a little frustrated when he didn't get it because he was open. And he was going to be open along the back edge of the end zone. And I don't think Justin Zwick saw him. And he pulled the ball down and started to run. And this is a huge down, my friend. They're all huge when you get to this point in the football game. This one's been bigger than any other that has come along. And they want to talk about it.
Ohio State can't afford a mistake. They take timeout. They're on the doorstep. Can they punch it in? We'll find out when we come back. 27-17 is our score. Ohio State ranked 6th in the country, but trailing by 10. This could be the play of the game. The Buckeyes need to get in the end zone. Manning Joe next to Justin Zwick in the backfield. Man in motion is Childress. Zwick on the rollout. Gets sandwiched and brought down. John Pickens.
Well, a senior. Franklin Lakes, New Jersey, has played one heck of a ball game. He's had a couple of big sacks. And they're going to need a field goal here anyway at some point in this ball game. Boy, what a great job. Good job defensively. Great corner. The defensive coordinator for Northwestern.
Mike Nugent. 1-for-1 so far on the day. 9 out of 10 on the year. He's only missed a 53-yarder. Mike Nugent makes it a 7-point game. A couple big third down plays. Set up this one. And on third down this time, Ohio State fails to get it done. Ohio State has not lost to Northwestern since 1971. But with 8 minutes and 46 seconds remaining, they trail by 7. Coming up immediately following this broadcast, Baseball Tonight will come your way. get post-game coverage on ESPN News post-game extra.
How about those Astros?
Houston guy can't stop thinking about baseball.
How about the Astros?
Ohio State on the year, on average, has given up 13 points per game. Today, they've given up two games worth already. Northwestern with 27 points, and that is a problem for Ohio State. Brett Bazinet has been the cat's pajamas for the Wildcats. He has been very accurate and very smart. Northwestern got a touchdown from Mark Fillmore, his first career touchdown. And defensively, the Wildcats were able to answer when needed. After a 16-play drive, Justin Swick is dropped in. The Yamaha game track, we notice why Randy Walker has to feel good. This team is doing just enough to pull off this upset. Brett Bazinet on the design rollout, throws across his body and misses Jonathan Field, the junior from Sweeney, Texas.
And they're going to have to keep clicking on all cylinders, because if you start throwing incompletions, it's going to stop the clock and give Ohio State an opportunity to further get themselves back in this ball game. So right now, the onus is on Brett Bazinet and this Northwestern offense. Throw some completions, move the football, chew up some clock, and maybe get some points on it, but you got to chew some clock.
Are you guaranteeing a run here?
Pretty much.
Noah Heron, no chance. Ohio State defensively needs to make a stand. It's third down and long yardage. Call it 10. Buckeye defense has not looked like the Buckeye defense we expected so far this evening. Twice as many points than normal, yeah. Almost twice as many passing yards, and well over 100 yards more total yards than they generally give up.
And on third downs, they came into this football game only allowing 27% conversion rate. Right now, they're up around 65 that they're giving up.
Mazinet. Cross intercepted with the pickoff, Bobby Carpenter. Big mistake for Bazinet and Northwestern. The Buckeyes have the ball in great field position.
They had the one pass get away from him in the first half. This one was the first football or pass that he's thrown. I thought he tried to force it. Right here, he tried to go with a pick scheme. Noah Heron clearing it out. And then underneath, right there, he tries to sneak it into Noah Heron. I think Jonathan Fields was the guy that was initially supposed to get the football. Bobby Carpenter is running on the spot. And once again, here we are with Ohio State at the end of a ball game, and the defense and special teams keep them in a position to win football games.
Pretty good athleticism by Bobby Carpenter on that grab. Ball is on the 22-yard line. The youngster, Pittman, with the football. Gain of three. Dominic Price on the force, along with Nick Roach. Ohio State. Intercepted two Brett Bazinet passes so far today.
Now he's kind of the guy that's overshadowed in this on this defense. A.J. Hawk, who gets a lot of publicity, but that junior, Bobby Carpenter, is fast, played free safety in high school, can move and make plays all over the football field. He is as talented as linebacker as there is on that team.
Swick.
So many times in this football game, you see Northwestern get there and they just can't finish the play. They come on a blitz to Justin Swift and he gets the football out. But Bam Childress here is able to make a guy miss a tackle, make another one miss, break another tackle, and all of a sudden he's inching closer and closer to the goal line.
First and goal. Pittman, the deep back, has the football, looking for the edge. No way. Great defensive play by Dominic Price. Brings him down for a loss of three.
He's known as one of the team's most physical players. Started now 24 games in a row. And right here, just playing leverage, outside leverage, taking on the big guard, Doug Dadish. He gets his pad level a little lower, can slip outside, and makes a great open field tackle.
Three receivers coming to the game for Ohio State. Buckeyes more competitive in the second half, but still trailed by seven.
Big, big turnaround in terms of yards for the Buckeyes here in the second half of this game.
Empty backfield. Swift. Oh, no, not what the doctor ordered. Great defensive play. John Pickens' second sack of the ball game. Loss of 13.
We just keep calling his name. I mean, just play after play after play. And it's, you know, a field goal's not going to do it at this point. You don't know when you're going to get the football back again. So you got to move it closer. I think maybe you kick it if you have to go down on fourth down and hope that your defense can get you the football back one more time. Be interesting to see. But John Pickens has played one outstanding football game. Held Ohio State with a big sack the previous possession. And allowed for Mike Nugent field goal.
It's touchdown or bust for Ohio State. Swift intercepted. Jeff Backus with the pick. The kid from Columbus.
Well, they have picked on the corners all night.
Northwestern with the ball and with momentum. They're up by seven. Ohio State, the sixth-ranked team in the country, down by seven. Justin Zwick threw a very critical interception just moments ago.
Yeah, here you're going to see three deep zone. Jeff Backus here, and the area the weaknesses are in here on this particular defense. Sometimes as a corner, you can set up a quarterback where they try to go down the seam, and Jeff Backus breaks on the football as Noah Heron is doing as well.
Good rush by Noah Heron, the senior. With a gain of 17 yards.
Yeah, Jeff Backus, they picked on him and the other corner, Marvin Ward, all night long. And then all of a sudden, you know, he sets him up thinking you got the seam, and he was like he was shot out of a cannon, getting underneath the football. And there was no doubt he was playing for the interception once Justin Zwick put the ball in the air.
Ohio State with two timeouts left. Down by seven, they can't afford to let Northwestern have a long drive. Heron dropped down at the 40-yard line. Show on turf. Not quite been the greatest show on turf so far this year.
No, but they're committing to throwing it, that's for sure.
Give on second down. Heron loses yardage. That'll bring up a third down and long for Northwestern.
Noah Heron kind of built for the pounding, 5'11", all 230 pounds of him. And he is just running between the tackles there. Ohio State's going to take a timeout, stop the clock.
We'll take a timeout. Ohio State needs a stop. Mark Schneider trying to urge on the boys. We'll see what happens when we come back. There's blood in the water here in Ryan Field, and that blood is scarlet. The scarlet and gray of Ohio State threaten. They're down by seven against the Northwestern Wildcats. Immediately following this broadcast, send it back to the studio, and we will have baseball tonight. Baseball's regular season winding down. Tomorrow, the last regular season games. A lot of excitement around the country. Third and seven. A lot of excitement here. Bazinet wants a big chunk. Sean Herbert had it and then dropped it.
All right. You know what? This week I'd have Herbert in the net just pummeling his hands with footballs because he's had an opportunity on several occasions to make big plays for his football team. There, well-thrown football just over the outstretched hands of the defender. And Sean Herbert should have caught that football. You touch it, you catch it. Sometimes they're difficult catches, but in a tight ball game like that, that's when you gotta have it.
on the incompletion. The clock stops. Ryan Huffman gives a low snap and kicks a low line drive punt. Dropped, picked up. Holmes. A little bit of daring do there. Brought down at the 30-yard line after a gain of two. A Big Ten action earlier today, the one non-conference game, the Purdue Boilermakers. Man, they continue to flex their muscle. A 25-point win in South Bend against Notre Dame.
Yeah, Purdue, they remain undefeated. Wisconsin over here, they remain undefeated. Minnesota, they remain undefeated. Wow. A lot of action around the Big Ten and some pretty good football being played.
Minnesota does not have to play Ohio State or Purdue this season. Remember that, folks. All right, Justin Zwick will run on first down. A little bit of shake, a little bit of bank. Out close to midfield. Brought down, but a good gain on first down. 18 yards on the pickup.
And clock will stop. Remember, in college football, the clock stops to move the chains once they're set. Go ahead and wind the clock again. But here, Justin Zwick. Back in the pocket, not a whole lot developing. And that's what we're talking about right there. The collapse of pocket, he steps up, making plays with his legs. Now, time to get on the ground. Get in a crowded area, cover the football up, get yourself down.
Buckeyes can't afford a mistake. Last possession ended with an interception. Zwick zips it out to Holmes. Close to another first down. Marvin Ward brings him down.
Well, that big, big cushion that Marvin Ward has given to Santonio Holmes. Look at that. Just pushing him off. Still right there. It's 5 yards different. He's going to catch the football. And when they need a play in the passing game, Ohio State, they have gone to that sideline where Marvin Ward lives. So, yeah, they know that their bread can be buttered on that side of the field.
First and 10. Lionel Ross back in the game. Zwick throws low, nothing doing. He was looking for Roy Hall, but it's now second and 10.
You want to go right back to that area again. You had some success, and all of a sudden you start going over there. I'd be surprised to see old Marvin Ward break on a football. They're trying to get over the top on him, and there he was lined up, looked like he was in press coverage and maybe bailed out. But they stopped the clock. First down and incompletion really doesn't do much for you. You got second and third down, and now you're in four down situation. And you got to use every down to try to score.
If we see Mike Nugent again, you'd assume it would be to kick a point after touchdown. Field goal won't do him much good. Zwick, complete. Greg Tolson, even better catch by Bam Childress, the fifth-year senior from Cleveland, Ohio.
And it's going to take a touchdown, and what a well-thrown football on a crossing route. Play action pass just holds Northwestern's linebackers just enough to allow Justin Zwick to get out of the pocket here. You see it underneath, holds everybody, Tim McGargle in the middle, and they allows for the crosser right here to come wide open for Bam Childress.
Ball on the 22-yard line. Justin Zwick maybe coming of age here. Thrown into the cauldron of Big Ten football for the first time. Zwick, touchdown, Ohio State.
And we talked about Marvin Ward having a target on his back. And every time they've needed to make a play, they've gone at him. And it's been Santonio Holmes against Marvin Ward. And right now, Santonio is winning that battle. We are long from being finished in this football game. Ohio State, once again, has gotten himself back in the game.
Mike Nugent hasn't missed an extra point in 2 years. He needs one here to tie it up. Remember, this has been the year of the missed extra point. Mike Nugent, such a special kicker. A little bit of drama, but an excellent one. Game. And Jim Tressel knew it all along.
Well, you know what? He never wavered. His body posture, everything just kind of told you he's been in battles like this before, seen his football team come back time after time. And when you don't capitalize and you don't put a
team like Ohio State away, when you have an opportunity, they will come back. And here it's just a post route. Timing post, five-step drop. He's going inside. Just right on time with the football. And over the top, Marvin Ward can't even make a play. I mean, he's just, it's just speed to burn. And when it's timed up just right, watch the reaction right there, their head coach. Just even keel the whole time.
He's absolutely giddy.
Yeah, not too excited. He still knows there's a lot of time on this clock.
Justin Zwick. Geez, you learn a lot sitting on the bench watching Greg Krenzel win a national championship, but you learn even more being out there in crunch time.
Yeah, and he had an opportunity to get his feet wet last year a little bit in ball games, and so that certainly helped him. But when you watch a veteran like Greg Krenzel and the seasons that he's had at Ohio State, you learn in a hurry. He's really had to grow up on the job.
It is high. Jeff Kaskis has it go through the wickets. Picks it up, breaks the tackle, and he's swarmed and brought down at the 11-yard line. Well, coming up next, immediately following this contest, it's Baseball Tonight with Josh Buchergrind, Jeff Brantley, and Tim Kirkjian, and the West is wild. Battles in both the National and American League Western Divisions. As the season comes to a close, the Chicago Cubs, well, the curse continues. The Cubs eliminated today. And, of course, Webb Jeff coming your way. Jeff Back is being attended to. He has played a very good game defensively. His first career interception just a couple of drives ago. He's had a couple of good kickoff returns. This game means a lot to him. He's a Columbus native, former Mr. Football in the state of Ohio his senior year. His team went 15-0 at Upper Arlington High School. They won the big school state championship. And guys on both teams right now paying close attention to Jeff Backus, as he is well known by both these teams.
Yeah, a lot of those guys have played against one another in high school, and I certainly hope that Jeff Backus is okay.
Ryan Huffman could be a big story in this game. If the Buckeyes can't hold Northwestern down on this end, Huffman will have to chance for a pressure kick. And earlier this year, pressure kicks weren't exactly his bag. He missed five field goals against Texas Christian, but since then, he has really rallied. Ryan Huffman has made five of his last six field goals, so he has faced adversity and overcome it. Being attended to, taken off the field. A buck 50 remaining in the Big Ten opener for Ohio State. Northwestern has played one Big Ten game already this year. They lost last week against the Minnesota Golden Gophers. First down, rush for good yards for Noah Heron.
That's one of those situations where you run the football and you see if you can move the chains. Now you get aggressive. You've gotten yourself some positive yards. You've gotten yourself from backed up against your own end zone. Now you can kind of take a more aggressive approach against Ohio State. But in the back of their minds, they're still remembering that last interception.
Terrell Jordan into the game. Mazenet. Keeper. Designed run. Gain 6, maybe 7 yards. Clock continues to move. Northwestern has all three timeouts at their disposal.
I think what Randy Walker's going to try to do is he wants to get Huffman and give Huffman a chance to kick the game winner. But he wants to do it without hardly any time left on the clock for Ohio State.
Bazinet trying to set up a screen. Pass is complete. Fillmore continues with the grab.
Now you get the timeout. Yeah, now you get the timeout. Bazinet right to the official to get the timeout call.
Brian Huffman maybe feeling a couple of butterflies. Will he be needed? Stick around. We'll have answers. First and 10 for Northwestern. Under a minute remaining. Throws that out of bounds. Second down and 10.
A smart decision. Come back and fight again on second down. Get the football out of bounds. You're going to stop the clock on an incomplete pass. Still with two timeouts left.
Need to get it around, right around here, around the 25-yard line. It's about where Huffman needs to have the football placed.
Huffman's got a big leg. Kicked a 63-yarder in high school. So far this year, as high as 48 yards. Screen busted up after a gain of one for Mark Fillmore. Block's going to run.
Now A.J. Hawk and Bobby Carpenter have seen that play a few times, and they recognize it, and now they're getting out there under the screen. So they're not able to complete it and run after the catch. They're catching it, but they're going right down.
Third and eight. Bazinet. Laying the wood, Nate Salley. Put some thump on. Fourth down and eight. Dangerous play.
Boy, they describe him as a big hitter when you talk to the coaching staff. Right there, I think Brett Bazinet let one get away. He threw it high, trying to go to his receiver, Mark Fillmore. And he paid the price. And you lay him out like that. I think this is a smart decision. Punt the football. Back Ohio State up.
Clock is stopped with 26 seconds remaining. Ohio State put some pressure on, but they can't get to the football. Fair catch is made by Santonio Holmes. So Jim Tressel's crew will have the football, but not much time to do any work. They have 20 seconds remaining. Mike Nugent could be the factor.
Once again.
We talked about it before. Hey, you got a Heisman Trophy. You shined it up back in 1989. If Mike Nugent somehow can make another field goal, will he make you a believer? Is this man a Heisman candidate?
No.
Oh! You get a vote, my man.
I told you, he would have to kick a game winner from now to the end of the season to get me to vote for a kicker to win the Heisman Trophy. There's no way.
Made a 55-yarder to win the game against Marshall a couple of weeks ago. Zwick going deep. Has a man all in and out of the breadbasket. Santonio Holmes had his man beat, but Marvin Ward with some closing speed may have gotten in the vision.
You know what? And if they're going to give you that kind of time to throw the football and allow for Santonio Holmes to get this deep, because he's open. I mean, he's open and leaving him right there. This one over the top. Marvin Ward just gets a hand in there to kind of distract him for a split second. They're going to allow it again. I'd take the shot one more time.
Ohio State lives for this. They have won 13 of their last 14 games that were decided by a touchdown or less.
Take a timeout. This will be the second overtime game, if we get there, for Northwestern this season.
Ohio State has burned their last time out.
You know, and Ohio State had to kick a 55-yarder against Marshall to avoid overtime. So,
Andre, if Ohio State should try a long pass like they just tried a moment ago, and they complete it, will they have time to run the length of the field? Of course, it'll be a first down, so the clock will stop.
Yes.
Have enough time to go in there, down the ball.
I think so. I really do, because the clock's going to stop to move the chains on a big, big play for a first down. You go down there, you have an opportunity to the clock at 13 seconds. College football, a lot of time. A lot of time. Can stop the clock just on a first down without having to call a timeout.
Mike Nugent lifetime. 5 out of 6 from over 50 yards. Ohio State probably needs to get to at least the 40-yard line. They need to pick up 40 yards on this play. Zwick has a big arm. Has time. Throws it up. Incomplete. Dangerous play. Intended for the sophomore Roy Hall, who made a dandy of a catch earlier in the second half.
Yeah, I don't know how much arm Justin Zwick has. But Santonio Holmes, even in prevent coverage, was still back there deep and getting deeper behind the secondary coverage of Northwestern. So I don't take a shot this way. I go right back to the other side.
Are you surprised that Ohio State is kind of freewheeling in this situation this close to their goal line?
No, not at all. Not at all. Game's tied. They're playing well enough defensively. I mean, take some shots.
This should be the final play in regulation, and it is. Justin Zwick takes the knee, and we have overtime, folks. Bonus football here from Evanston, Illinois. Jim Tressel doesn't mind throwing his hat in the ring with overtime football. He's won his last four overtime games. Bonus football here at Ryan Field. No extra charge, folks. 27-27 is our score. Ohio State trying to remain undefeated. It's their first Big Ten game. Northwestern trying to get up off the schneid. They're just 1-for-3 on the year. But they haven't played like a 1-and-3 team so far in this evening.
No, they hadn't. You know, Ohio State's been in games like this so many times. They just hadn't flinched. Yeah, if you're in overtime in college football, I think you play defense first, because then you know what you have to go out and do once you get the football, and you can play for the win. If you hold Ohio State to a field goal, then you know you're trying to play for a touchdown, or at least you get a field goal to send it again to another overtime, but you can play for a touchdown with the football game.
Jim Tressel imploring Justin Zwick not to make mistakes. Mistakes in overtime just kill you. You got to make sure you get some kind of point on the board. Second half has been dicey. Ohio State found themselves down by 10 points a couple of times. Mark Fillmore did some damage against them. His first career touchdown. But Ohio State came roaring back. Big play to Roy Hall. Touchdown by Lionel Ross.
And then Brett Bazinet comes back, hits Jonathan Fields, and gets him close to the goal line. But Noah Herring plunges it in from the 1 yard line.
Ohio State, just moments ago, had their prayers answered. Santonio Holmes, so athletic. 21 yard touchdown grab. And that tied it up to 27 apiece. Antonio Holmes with 99 yards receiving. For Northwestern, Noah Herron has gone over the century mark in rushing yards. Ohio State in the second half has basically matched Northwestern yard for yard. In the first half, they were flat out getting outplayed.
Yeah, it really was. And, you know, that's the sign of a good football coach. If you can go in at halftime and make the proper adjustments to get your football team back in the game, know the weaknesses of what Northwestern were doing, and they took advantage.
Both teams will have possession of the football here in this overtime period. Ohio State with first crack runs the youngster Antonio Pittman for a gain of 3. Ohio State will try and put some points on the board, and then Northwestern can match. And if they don't, the game is over.
I think, you know, you hit the nail on the head when you said you have to come away with some type of points. You cannot have turnovers in overtime, because that's the quickest way. Then you just turn around, kick a field goal, and go home. But look at this, 10 of 11. Mike Nugent, just an unbelievable weapon for Ohio State.
The senior, Lionel Ross, back in the game in the backfield next to Zwick. Second down. Zwick throws an out pass, and it's dropped by Holmes. That would have gotten him over 100 yards, but it slips through the fingers.
That's one that Justin Zwick wishes he had back. That timing route to the outside, and he just throws it about a half yard too far from his receiver. Here, just pushing off. Jeff Backus, they're going to pick on him because he went down with an injury a little while ago. Still limping right there.
Third down and 7. From here, it would be close to a 40-yard field goal. Zwick with time. time running out. Has to throw it out of bounds.
Good pressure by Tim McGargle, the middle linebacker. They sent him on a blitz. He's able to get there. Justin Zwick almost held onto the football a little bit too long. Totally getting me worried that he's going to take a sack, and boy, all of a sudden it would have become a really, really long field goal.
Mike Nugent already 2 for 2 today. With this 40-yard attempt, should he make it, he would tie Dan Stoltz for the most field goals at Ohio State. This would be his 59th of his career. No good! Mike Nugent misses from 40 yards.
Wow. You guys are ready to pass out a Heisman. What's today? October 2nd.
First weekend in October.
To a kicker. And here, just plenty of distance. Doesn't come in like he's expecting it to, and stays wide right.
So, with this Nugent miss, the Northwestern Wildcats, all they need is a field goal of their own to defeat Ohio State for the first time since 1971.
And Noah left, Noah right, and hold on to the football and give Brian Huffman a chance. I still think they're going to have to get it a little bit closer. He's got a strong leg, but you still want the luxury of a chip shot over a 40-yarder.
Baseball tonight, the crew standing by. They will come your way immediately following this game here in Ryan Field. Second down and long. Designed quarterback run. Bazinet. Pushed out of bounds inside the 5. 19-yard gain.
And what a fantastic call. And when they emptied the backfield, you had to know that it was going to be a quarterback draw and not take the risk of putting the ball in the air and throwing an interception and having a turnover. There, it was just so well blocked up front by the big offensive line of Northwestern. Brett Bazinet here. They can go to Noah Heron, maybe push this thing in the end zone and get out of here.
Northwestern doesn't want to settle for a field goal. Heron. Won't get close to the goal line.
Not so sure. I just don't go ahead, kick this thing and go.
He missed twice game of the year in overtime.
You have to deal the ball. The center has to snap it. The quarterback's got to get the quarterback-center exchange. He's got to hand it to the running back. A lot of things can take place when you're handing the football off. You have just an opportunity to snap, hold, kick, go home.
Jim Trussell's had a four-leaf clover. Wrapped him top of a lucky horseshoe over the last couple of years. Heron wins the game! A gorilla has jumped off the back of the Northwestern Wildcats. They hadn't defeated Ohio State in Evanston since 1950. They hadn't beaten them anywhere since 1971. Cat scratch fever here in Evanston. Let's go down in the field. Jimmy Nikes is standing by with one happy camper.
Coach, you just knocked off the number 6 team in the country. How did you do it?
Well, I give a lot of credit to our coaching staff. I think they did a great job. Mike Dunbar on offense, Greg Colby on defense. Our kids worked the plan. They trusted and believed. It was a great day for us.
How about the play of your running backs and your offense overall, not turning the ball over, taking care of it, and finding a way to win? You talked about it yesterday, and it came true.
Well, we did a good job up front. I thought we really played maybe our best game on offense. Offensive line did a great job. James Patton got them playing, and No, stuck it in there. It's a good day for us.
All the wins you've had, where does this one rank?
Oh, it's pretty high up there, right? but you know, it feels good right now, and I'm thrilled for our kids. Yeah, it all goes back to them, and they did a great job today, hung in there. Hope they have a good time tonight.
I'm sure they will, Coach. Yeah, well. Congratulations. Oh, sure. See you down the road, guys.
Thank you, Jimmy. Well, Andre, it was a great one.
Yes.
I'm sure you did as well. Our final score in overtime, Northwestern beats Ohio State 33-27. Ohio State now 0-1 in Big Ten play. Coming up next, it's Baseball Tonight over on ESPN. Game Day Final is currently airing. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. For Andre Ware, Jimmy Dykes, Tom Eric Collins, saying so long from Evanston.